evening, everybody, and welcome into 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships, live from the beach in Longport, New Jersey. What a beautiful night for racing. It's Friday, the 13th of August. Help us call the show, call the race, is Scotty McKay, former lieutenant of the Ocean City Beach Patrol and former chief of the Longport Beach Patrol, Dan Adams. But guys, it's great to be back here at the South Jersey Championships in Longport, New Jersey. Dan, the site of Longport's won the last four in a row. They're dominating.
Yeah, it's been a great 4 years for Longport. They've really put a true team together. A lot of tough competitors. You know, we had the Tepper brothers swimming and Mike Mcgrath and Sean Duffy rowing. You really put a good team together. But what a beautiful night. It's very similar to last 2 years ago when we were here. The only difference is we had that little shower come through right when we got ready to get started.
Yeah, and Scooter McKay, the weather's perfect. The wind's out of the south-southeast, not blowing too hard. The water temperature is about 73, 74. Couldn't ask for a better night for racing.
No, these are perfect conditions. I mean, there's not a lot of chop out there. I mean, it's going to be great for the rowers and for the swimmers who like that kind of race. You know, some guys like it really choppy and blowing hard because, you know, that's their kind of race. So it's going to be fun tonight. It's going to be it's a clear night to see everything, too.
Yeah, it's beautiful. And, of course, this is the granddaddy of them all, you guys. This is the Super Bowl of lifeguard racing, the South Jersey Lifeguard Champions. Now, whoever wins this race will host the race next year at their home at their beach. And Dan, like I just said, alluded to a few seconds ago, Longport's been dominant, and that's why we've been here the last few years.
And Bill, they've had a really great season so far. They've won the Longport Memorials. They won the Dutch Hoffman Memorials. They won the Margate Memorials last week. You look, though, some of the changes happened last week as far as the doubles and singles, as far as the competitors and who finished where. And like I said to you last week, I'll say it again tonight, and like I said it 2 years ago, this race is going to come down to the top five doubles crews. We'll talk about them as we get a little closer, and it's going to be five or six in the singles. The swim has been cut and dry. The top three in all the races have been the same three. It's been Joey Tepper, it's been Dolan Grisbound, it's been Zach Vassar from Margate. There was a couple little differences last week. You had Lewis from...
Jack Lavari from, Stone Harbor was
yeah,
in
you
the
had,
mix.
You had Brendan Lewis come in fourth and Jack Lavari fifth. So there are some changes. There's a little shakeup, but, you know, it's going to be a great night for racing. We're going to have a great time here. And hats off to Longport. They got this race together and got things going.
And now, Scotty McKay, you know that we've talked about this several times before, that Mother Nature plays a big part in these races. Doesn't seem like Mother Nature is going to be too much of a factor tonight because the ocean's pretty calm as we watch the swimmers getting their strokes in preparation for tonight's race. You got some doubles crews out there, got a couple singles crews. But the conditions, Scooter, overall, not too bad. Pretty docile ocean tonight.
No, what people don't understand about these races, have never been to one, is there's a lot of strategy that goes on here. You know, I mean, the swim is only, 12 to 13 minutes, and you got to know, you got to come in, swim out straight, and come back in straight. And you're guided by whatever you decide to pick. It might be the tower back here where they want to finish, but if you start making mistakes and drifting far north or something like that, it can take, you could drop you down three or four places. Same thing with the boat, you know.
We're broadcasting live here from the beach in Longport, New Jersey. It's the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. And Dan Adams, you know that this is more than just an event. It's a reunion. The beach patrols from Cape May Point to Brigantine are all involved in this big race. It dates back to 1924, and it's very competitive. It's for the bragging rights of South Jersey, which, Dan, these races are a part of South Jersey lore. I mean, since 1924, it's a tradition.
Yeah, and we talked about that. This is our Friday nights. This is our Super Bowl. This is our World Series championship. This is, the South Jersey Cup's like holding on to the Vince Lombardi trophy when it's all said and done. And like you said, those bragging rights, they do last all year. And it is a good feeling to win. And, it's an open field tonight. You know, you look at the finish that Dave Funk had last week, both in the doubles and the singles. He had a great night. He finished second in the doubles with his partner Brett Hansen. He finished first in the singles. Mike Mcgrath and Sean Duffy have been tough all year. They're, we talked about it. They have the bullseye on their back. They're the team to beat. They're the team that everybody's gunning for. But here we go. We got Chuck Gowdy and Chris Graves back in the mix.
Back in the mix.
2019 South Jersey champions. So,
Scotty McKay, talk about tradition, the people that are involved in these races, it's a lot of work. You've set these flags and you've done the work to prepare. It's not easy for the host town.
No, I would think Dan's probably getting tired of doing this. but, you know, he doesn't want to lose that because hosting it is a great thing because it means you won the year before. But, yeah, it's not – everybody thinks the ocean is straight. You know, it ends here, and it's a line, and the flags go just right out from there. They don't. The beach moves and turns. You don't see it from here necessarily, but you've got to plant this. So we spent a lot of time and a lot of work to make sure that those races were fair, and that's really important to the guys that are rowing.
And tell us what's involved with setting the flags. You did it a lot for Ocean City in your years as a lieutenant in the Ocean City Beach Patrol. Describe to our listeners what it entails.
Well, we used to, it's funny, in Ocean City, we used to have a window at 39th Street on a dormer window on a side of a house, and then we would have a tower, the most southern leg on a tower that we would do. All of a sudden, they started tearing down houses and building new houses. Where'd the dormer window go on that one house? It's gone. They built a new house there. So you do it with a compass. You sit out there. The ocean's moving. The flags are moving back and forth. It's not a. I'll tell you, there's a lot of funny stories where, you know, you clip on a big 5-gallon ice cream jug and you fill it with concrete with a hoop in it and you tie your weight onto that for your flag. Well, I don't know how many times guys threw the weight over, forgot to clip the flag on. So in Ocean City, there's probably about 35 weights sitting out in the middle of the ocean somewhere.
I'll tell you what, it's a beautiful night here for the South Jersey Lifeguard Championship. The beach is starting to fill in. The patrols are out practicing. They're getting their strokes in. Dan, I look forward to a great race. It's a beautiful night, and anything can happen in these events. You know, you get guys that maybe didn't place or came in fourth, fifth, and all of a sudden they can have a great day and change the whole dynamic of the race.
They can, and when we talked last week, we didn't have Brendan Lewis in the top five when we were talking pre-race, and he came out and finished fourth. You know, and going back to talking about in preparation for this race, one, let's look at the south and the north. We have the Manor Avenue pipe to the south, and we have the 33rd Avenue pipe to the north. That's pretty much going to be your boundaries for tonight. But let's talk about Longport preparing for this race. 2 days ago, Chief Matt Kelm wasn't feeling well, got tested, came back positive. Here's a healthy individual. Was feeling fine, and all of a sudden now he's out with COVID. And here is your chief, who's running your beach patrol, isn't here. And everybody stepped up. All the lieutenants, all the beach patrol members stepped up and did a great job to prepare for this race. And everybody took on another aspect that they normally didn't have to do. But, Matt, we know you're listening out there. We wish you well. We're sorry you can't be here with us tonight, but we know you're here with us in spirit, and you're going to be rooting Longport along, as well as you know me. Billy knows I'm a little biased up here, and I do my best.
That's why we got Scotty McKay here to balance things out.
I do my best during the course of the night. But, Matt, I hope you're feeling better, and we wish you nothing but the best.
We second that. Absolutely. Second and third that, Matt. All right, 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships is brought to you by Mcgann Reelers of Sea Isle City, a family tradition since 1939. 4111 Lannis Avenue in Seattle City. Home sales, summer rentals, 609-263-7422. And by Blitz's Market in Ocean City. Order online at blitzmarket.com. Located at 21st and 34th Street on Asbury Avenue in Ocean City. 609-399-9983. Blitz's Market, home of the dill pickle hoagie. It's really a big dill. And by famous Dino's Subs and Pizza of Margate. 8016 Ventnor Avenue in Margate. Dine in or take out, 609-822-6602. Let's go, Margie. And by 7th and 11th Street Bike and Surrey Rentals, located at the Boardwalk in Ocean City, open 7 days a week, 7:30 a.m. to 12 noon, in business for over 30 years. Enjoy riding the Ocean City Boardwalk on great bikes with friendly service, 609-425-5169. And by Leeds Builders, 30 years of building beautiful custom homes. Are you ready for your beautiful house by the sea? Call Leeds Builders, 609-822-4506. When we return, we'll set the race up. We'll look at some of the racers and the competitors. You're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. Saturday morning in the locker room with Billy Schweim, the Phillies and the Reds hook up for a 3-game set. Can they hold on to the lead in the NL East? We will recap Game 1. Former Phillies manager of the 2008 World Series championship team, Charlie Manuel, joins us to talk about the Phillies retiring Roy Halladay's number 34. The Eagles play the Steelers Thursday night in South Philly, and we will review the first preseason action. It's the locker room with Billy Schweim, Saturday morning from 10 a.m. to noon on 97.3 ESPN.
On some models, excludes Corvette with GM financing, excludes price. See dealer for details.
Have you seen what some dealers are now charging for new cars and used vehicles? It's outrageous. But at Bennett Chevrolet, you still pay what GM supplier employees pay for brand new Chevys. Plus, Bennett gives you all the rebates. That's not either or. You get both. And that can save you up to 25% off MSRP. And Bennett has 0% financing available to save you even more. Got a trade? Bennett's paying top dollar. And we mean top dollar. A minimum $7,000 towards any pre-owned in stock. That's a minimum $7,000 for any old clunker you can tow to our lot. And if it's in good shape, we'll pay more. And we'll buy your vehicle even if you don't buy one of ours. And Bennett makes it so easy. No sales pressure, no negotiating, just pure joy. Because our non-commissioned sales staff is paid on your satisfaction, not how much you spend. So you can see why nobody beats Bennett Chevrolet. Nobody. Find new roads at Bennett Chevy, Egg Harbor Township, and BennettChevy.com.
For over 110 years, Calvi Electric has been a trusted name in South Jersey for premier electrical commercial work. Now, through their newly developed residential division, they're available for all of your electrical needs, including installing power and lighting, new security systems and upgrades, generators, car charging stations, and solar panel systems for your home and business. Calvi Electric's sign department, as always, is available for your business, too. To find out how they can help your home or business, visit calvielectric.com or call 609-345-0151.
I'm Mike Mackler. At Goldenberg Mackler, we represent you, not the insurance companies. When seriously injured in any type of accident, call us. We'll speak with you for free and fight to get you the money you deserve. When injured, make the right call to Goldenberg Mackler.
For the best lawyer, call Goldenberg Mackler. With four convenient locations to better serve you, Atlantic City, Northfield, Rio Grande, and Vineland. Call us at 609-344-7131.
I'm New Jersey Secretary of Agriculture Doug Fisher. Whether you like them sweet or spicy, Jersey Fresh bell and hot peppers liven up any dish, and they are in season now at your favorite farm market, farm stand, or supermarket. Stay loyal to local Jersey Fresh peppers.
Welcome back to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships live from the beach in Longport, New Jersey. It's the granddaddy of them all, the Super Bowl of lifeguard racing here in South Jersey. Scott McKay, former Ocean City Beach Patrol Lieutenant, Chief of the Longport Beach Patrol, former Chief of the Longport Beach Patrol, Dan Adams up here in the booth. We're right at the water's edge. We got a bird's eye view, Dan.
You know what? We can't get any closer than this. We're literally on top of the swim finish. But we can see every lane. We can see everything here. It's a clear enough night. There's a little haze out there, but it's still clear enough to see the double singles and the swim. And what a great night for racing. And like you said, the crowd is getting big. We're getting ready for a great night. And just happy to be here, Bill.
You know, Scooter, you can feel the passion and the excitement build throughout the week, talking to guys on the boardwalk and you know, just talking to Dan Adams, getting in preparation for the race. All the Beach Patrols look forward to this particular night, Scooter.
Yeah, this is the big one. I mean, this is what everybody – I mean, some of the other ones that are earlier in the season, they have a lot more events, which makes it more fun for the guys and gets different people. Dan and I had this conversation a week ago about should we have guys not do double events, stuff like that. But it gets other people involved from your Beach Patrol, and it's good for them. It's good for the morale and everything else. So,
and we talked last week, Dan, and the previous week we did the Dutch Hoffmans from Wildwood. We did the Margate Memorials. We noticed that this year we had eight guys double up, row doubles and singles. And that's got to take a lot out of you.
It does. And you know, and when we talked about it last week, Scott, and you know, you can echo this, but I think that these competitors earned their spot, they earned their position, they earned their chance to represent their city in both events because they won both events for each city, and they earned it. And you know what? If they're ready, that's awesome, and it's awesome that they're prepared. You know, let's talk about some of these competitors here tonight.
Yeah, let's get into the racers because we got a couple veteran crews, the doubles crews especially, Atlantic City, Granese and Kyle Deroo. They've been together for some time, and of course, Erich, Wolf, and Jack Lom from Avalon, Brigantine, the Savelle brothers, Jack and Joe, Mike Fitzpatrick, and Gabe Brooker from Cape May. Cape May Point does not have an entry this year, Scooter. Longport, perennial champions, Mike Mcgrath and Sean Duffy. Margate, another outstanding crew that's won numerous races. Chuck Gowdy and Chris Graves are back together for the first time this year. North Wildwood, Sean Stamm, and James Kimmery. Ocean City, Jackson Kirkscooter. Does that name ring a bell?
Well, sure does.
And A.J. Oves. And, of course, C.L. Danny Rogers and Pat Scampico. Stone Harbor, Dennis Bakey and Tom Lake. Upper Township, Andrew Tobiasen and Joe O'Neill. Ventnor, always a tough crew. Dan, Brett Henson, and David Funk. Wildwood, Fitzpatrick Jr. and Steve Mcgann. And then, of course, Wildwood Crest with Terry McGovern and Derek Koborowski. And those guys, all veterans, only a few rookies and guys with little experience in these boats, Dan.
Yeah, and we talked about that last week when we had Mike and Sean up here. You know, it's a tough season for them. They're the ones everybody's gunning for. And like Dave Funk said, Mike and Sean have set the pace that everybody's following. And that's a lot of pressure going into this race here tonight. You're going into the South Jersey Championships undefeated, and you have to put yourself out there and do the best you can. But, you know, I just got some of the lane assignments, and I think it's kind of ironic, but two things.
And
one,
before we get into the lane, Scooter, talk to us. How do they determine who's in what lane?
It's a draw. All the the representative from each beach patrol goes up to the headquarters here, and they draw for lanes. You know, so the
popsicle sticks. I think it is.
Yeah,
the names.
They've used popsicle sticks over the years. They've all different kinds of things. So, and that can make a difference. A lane can make a difference depending on the wind's blowing and stuff like that. So it can definitely change what your strategy is going to be.
The lanes can make a difference, and actually how they do it this year, it was in envelopes with the sealed, and the lane was, you know, that's how it was picked. So sealed out envelopes. But what I started to say there about the lanes is, in lane one is Longport, and lane two is Margate. So
wow,
you got Duffy,
wow, the neck to neck.
Duffy and Mcgrath and Gowdy and Graves going there. And ironically, Ventnor picked lane 13 on Friday the 13th.
How about that?
How about it, huh?
And, you know, look wow. at it. Look, you know, you can never count out a Funk brother. I mean, look at the Funk family. Didn't the brothers Funk win the doubles and singles 1 year? 3 years in a row, I believe.
Absolutely.
These guys know what they're doing, Scotty McKay.
Yeah, so, Bill, if you want, I can give you a quick rundown
of all
the lanes.
So,
lane one, we got Longport. Lane two, we got Margate. Lane three, Atlantic City. Lane four, Wildwood. Lane five, Brigantine. Lane six, Cape May Point. Lane seven, Avalon. Lane eight, Upper Township. Lane nine, Cape May. Lane 10 is Stone Harbor. Lane 11 is North Wildwood. Lane 12 is Ocean City. Lane 13 is Ventnor. Lane 14 is Sea Isle. Lane 15, Wildwood Crest.
And as we watch the doubles crews preparing, you got cool boats. You got an orange boat out there. You got a green boat. You got a light blue boat. It's easy to spot, but the ones that are white, they're the ones that are hard to pick up.
Yeah, right.
Especially when they get in.
I mean, they do put numbers on the boats in the bow now, which is great. It kind of helps, you know, give you a chance, but they're coming in straight at us. It's not easy to see those.
Now, Dan, this race, when we set up our tent up here, it was like high to medium tide. When the race starts, it'll be low tide. They'll have to go through a gully and then a sandbar.
Yeah, and we were talking about that with one of the lieutenants here before we got set up, and I don't think it's going to drop a lot more than it already has. I think we're looking at kind of where the tide's going to be. And it might come up a little bit on us, but I think we're in pretty good shape, and it gives us enough space. But what a view we have here, and how outstanding is it is that we're sitting here for the 2021 South Jersey Championship after everything we've gone through in the past year. It's just a great night and a great night for racing.
And, of course, we wish Matt Kelm could be here tonight, but he's going to be listening to the broadcast, and we'll keep him informed. As we'll keep all the listening audience, if you can't make it down to Longport, obviously you can listen to the broadcast right here on 97.3 ESPN.
And just to interject one thing, because Matt did text me during the off time there, during the break. He texted me to let me know he was fully vaccinated and still got this virus.
Wow.
So,
wow.
He, you know, just tells people, you got to be, you know, safe, you got to be prepared. And hey, you know what, let's not get into politics, but people need to get out there, get vaccinated, and do what's right to make this a safe environment for
Absolutely.
All of us.
Absolutely.
All right, 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships brought to you by Mcgann Realtors of Seattle City, a family tradition since 1939, 4111 Landis Avenue in Seattle City. Home sales, summer rentals, 609-263-7422. And by Blitz's Market in Ocean City, New Jersey. Order online at blitzesmarket.com, located at 21st and 34th Street on Asbury Avenue in Ocean City, 609-399-9983. Blitz's home of the dill pickle hoagie. It's really a big dill. and by famous Dino's Subs and Pizza of Margate, 8016 Ventnor Avenue in Margate. Dine in or take out, 609-822-6602. Let's go Margate. And by 7th and 11th Street Bike and Surrey Rentals, located at the Boardwalk in Ocean City, New Jersey. Open 7 days a week, 7:30 a.m. to 12 noon. In business for 30 years. Enjoy riding the Ocean City Boardwalk on great bikes with friendly service, 609-425-5169. And by Leeds Builders, 30 years of building beautiful custom homes. Are you ready for your beautiful house by the sea? Call Leeds Builders, 609-822-4506. All right, when we return, we'll have the beginning of the 81st annual South Jersey Lifeguard Championships live from the beach in Longport.
Tonight on Compass Media Network's coverage of the NFL. The 2021 season gets underway as the Cowboys and Cardinals kick off the preseason from Arizona. Hi, this is Jerry Recco. Join Kevin Ray, Danny White, and myself for all the action as the Cowboys square off with Kyler Murray and the Cardinals. Football is back. It's the Dallas Cowboys and the Arizona Cardinals. If it's the NFL, it's right here.
Coverage begins at 9:30 on 97.3 ESPN.
On some models, excludes CoreVet with GM financing, excludes price. See dealer for details.
Have you seen what some dealers are now charging for new cars and used vehicles? It's outrageous. But at Bennett Chevrolet, you still pay what GM supplier employees pay for brand new Chevys. Plus, Bennett gives you all the rebates. That's not either or. You get both. And that can save you up to 25% off MSRP. And Bennett has 0% financing available to save you even more. Got a trade? Bennett's paying top dollar, and we mean top dollar. A minimum $7,000 towards any pre-owned in stock. That's a minimum $7,000 for any old clunker you can tow to our lot. And if it's in good shape, we'll pay more. And we'll buy your vehicle even if you don't buy one of ours. And Bennett makes it so easy. No sales pressure, no negotiating, just pure joy. Because our non-commissioned sales staff is paid on your satisfaction. Faction, not how much you spend. So you can see why nobody beats Bennett Chevrolet. Nobody. Find new roads at Bennett Chevy, Egg Harbor Township, and BennettChevy.com.
Oh, according to research, 82% of people remember radio ads. That means that 82% of you listening right now will remember that this is an ad for ZipRecruiter. If you're hiring, 82% of you will recall that ZipRecruiter makes hiring faster and easier. And 82% of you will note that you can try ZipRecruiter for free today. But you have to go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. Yes, free. 82% of you will keep in mind that ZipRecruiter's technology finds qualified people for your job and actively invites them to apply.
Scott, is that you? Who are you talking to?
82% of you will also know that I, live with my mom. But the most important thing to note is that ZipRecruiter works. In fact, 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Will you be part of the 82% who remember where you can try ZipRecruiter for free? It's ZipRecruiter.com/free. Again, that exclusive link is ZipRecruiter.com/free. How much? Free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Why would someone looking for a mortgage at the Jersey Shore take a loan from a company in Detroit or North Carolina or some other far-off place? Online mortgages promise a lot but don't always deliver. First Bank of Sea Isle City knows the Jersey Shore. We are local lenders. We use local appraisers and provide in-house processing. We understand the unique obstacles of financing in Cape May County. Don't take a chance. Local banking is better. Let us guide you. First Bank of Sea Isle City.
Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
It's back to school, and at Matt Blatt Kia, our math is easy. Put zero down, make zero payments for 90 days, or pay 0% financing for 60 months on every new 2022 Kia Stinger and Sportage in stock. Plus, we need your trade. We'll even buy it for cash, even if you don't buy a Kia from us. Used car values are at an all-time high. Your car may be worth more than you think. Worried about your credit? Forget it. We finance your future, not your past. All new 2021 Kia Niro EXEV with zero due at signing and zero security deposit. Lease just $275. Five per month. It's basic math. Zero down, zero payments, or zero interest for 60 months.
It's gotta be a Matt Black here.
Offers with approved tier 1 or 2 credit through Kia Motors Finance. Not all will qualify. 0% based on 1667 per 1,000 borrow. Negative equity financed into new loan. Nero 36 month lease 10,000 miles per year. Excludes taxes, title, license, and docking. Offers don't combine. Call 877-289-6670 or go to MattBlackKiaNJ.com for complete details. Expires 9-6-2021.
Matt Black Kia 6211. Black Horse Pike. Egg Harbor Township.
And now on Route 37 in Tom's River.
Really? No way. That's what visitors at International Bird Rescue say when learning we rely on Dawn dish soap to clean wildlife. The same Dawn they use at home to wash dishes. Yep, helping save wildlife is...
so Dawn easy.
The Philadelphia Eagles play on 97.3 ESPN-FM. This Eagles season, listen to every game with the voice of the Eagles, Merrill Reese and Mike Quick. Pre-game coverage from the Eagles Radio Network starts 1 hour before kickoff. Your official home for Eagles football in South Jersey is 97.3 ESPN-FM. Brought to you locally by...
Boardwalk Honda. From Maine to Miami, nobody beats a Boardwalk deal. Online at BoardwalkHonda.com. Calvi Electric, now offering residential services for your home and business. First Bank of Sea Isle, Cape May County's community bank. GMS Law, make the right call with four convenient locations to serve you. Visit GMSLaw.com. Cape Regional Health System, for a healthier life. Call 609-463-CAPE. And BMW of Atlantic City, closer than you think. Online at bmwatlanticcity.com.
Welcome back to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. Right here on 97.3 ESPN, we've been covering the races all year long. Dan and Scotty McKay. And it's culminating into this final race of the year, Dan. We still have a few races left, the Gowdies and a couple other races, but this is the last big race. I mean, this is the championship. This is what it all comes down to, Dan.
This is the creme de la creme. You know, this is our South Jerseys. This is our Super Bowl. And let me tell you, these competitors are fired up. They're ready to go, and they're looking forward to this race more than you can imagine. And the preparation that they did to get here is tenfold. They've been warming up, practicing here tonight, but they've been getting ready since the beginning of time. And when I say that, they've been out rowing all winter. They've been preparing as soon as the season kicked in. They're rowing twice a day, just like two-a-days in football. Lifeguards are rowing twice a day. And remember what Sean Duffy said in the interview. We row in the afternoon on purpose because the conditions are going to be like that for us during the race. So let's look for a great race here tonight. I can't wait till it gets started.
Now, Scooter McCaters, I mean, this beach is packed. I mean, you can see people just filing down here on the beach. And all the beach patrols, the doubles crews are at the water's edge. And Scooter, we're almost at race time. And it's pretty exciting stuff.
I'll tell you what. I think the tide is just about turned at this point. It's starting to look like it's starting to come back this way a little bit.
Better not.
We could be in a pool here at one point.
I think we're going to be just fine. We're going to be okay. And
we trust Dan.
Kate May just came in from warming up, so we got a little time here with them. But we'll be okay. We'll make this happen. And you know what? We got 14 to 16 minutes of rowing going to happen here in a few minutes. Then we got 12 to 14 minutes for the swim, and then 4 to 6 minutes for the singles. It's going to go quick. It's going to be a great night. And hats off to all of these competitors here tonight.
You know, Scotty McKay, over the years, we've had some beach patrols. They get on a roll. They dominate. If you look at some of the history of the races and the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships date back to 1924, but it looks like they go on runs, these beach patrols. Like Ocean City from 1968 to 1971, won four in a row. Atlantic City is in the mix. Margate, of course, has dominated. Then Ocean City again from 75 to 78. Then Margate has been dominant lately. So, they go in runs.
Well, you look back at here, Chuck Gowdy's been, since the early 2000s, he's been actually winning a lot of these races with different guys. So he's one of the multiple guys here that's really going to be pushing to get this thing win tonight. So it's going to be tough.
Yeah, and this is his first race tonight of the season. Obviously, he's had his inner city races, but this is his first time rowing out of town tonight. And what a great night to bring it out and show what he's got. And, you know, I believe Chuck has 10 South Jersey championships. He is the leader on the board. He has the most titles of any competitor, you know, that's raced in South Jersey. And when we talked to Mr. Mcgann last week, we talked about we need a Hall of Fame for lifeguards. We need something there. And Chuck Gowdy would be one of the first people to put in that Hall of Fame based on his stats and his performance.
I think I just counted 11.
Yeah. And, of course, you know, look at the Funk family over the years.
We do.
I mean, Scooter McKay, they've dominated.
Yeah.
Talk about a family that dominate a sport. There's a...
Talk about pedigree.
Pedigree,
you know,
right?
Like they've passed it down. And I remember the father for years winning big races back when I started, Dennis.
And we did talk about that, and we talked about that with Dave. I mean, you know, look, Dave and Andrew.
All right, the doubles crews are actually getting the boat to the water's edge. And we got, what do we have? Crest to the south, and we have
Ocean City and
Margate to the far north.
Yeah, we got lane 1 to the north.
We're right
in
the
lane 15 to the south.
We're right in the dead middle. We've got the Upper Township, Cape May right directly in front of us with Stone Harbor, and we're getting ready. The flags are up. Both ends are ready to go, Scotty McKay and I.
This is the point, man.
This is where it starts, man.
And starts are crucial, even in doubles races. You know, you want to get in the boat and get it going right away.
The red flag's getting ready to go up. I can see them. They got it steady, but it's getting ready to go up. As soon as that goes up, it's going to be a quick start.
You can hear the excitement in the air. The crowd's all getting pumped up. When the flag goes up, we're almost moments away from the start of the 81st annual South Jersey Lifeguard Championships from Longport, New Jersey. And we have a great crowd here tonight. The racers are in the water's edge, and they're grabbing the fall pin, Scooter, to try to keep
the flag is up. There it goes.
And they're off.
Race is off. Here we go.
CL gets off to a good start. Avalon, Brigantine really gets a nice start. These are short strokes in the beginning.
Some of the teams.
Margate's got a nice start as well.
Yeah. Gowdy and Graves.
This is a long enough race. There's plenty of time to recover.
You know, and let's talk about that a little bit. You know, you got a long race here. You got to set your pace. You got to be prepared. And we talked about the course stuff. You got to be looking over your shoulder every few strokes. You got to have your line on something. You talked about those double bay windows you were looking for before. You got to look for this for course and keeping everything in line. So here we go. It's off to a good start. And hopefully we can get some updates here and keep everybody posted. Our listeners out there, we're happy to have them, and we look forward to it.
And while the race is off, let's bring into the box up here, right at the water's edge, a former champion of the doubles race from Ocean City Beach Patrol 1986, John Malar. He's also one of our great sponsors of the 7th and 11th Street Bike and Surrey Rentals, located on the boardwalk in Ocean City. Hey, John, welcome into the booth.
Thanks.
You're pumped up. John, tell us a little bit about your preparation for this race. This is a big race, man.
I was hoping you would ask me that, because it all starts the morning you wake up of the morning of the race. And, you know, as you see the starters with the poles.
Yeah.
This guy's like knee high.
This guy's drowning.
Yeah, so when we talked about it's, you know, the beach isn't straight. It's not even. So, John Millard.
What?
John. When your preparation for this race, talk to us about what you went through.
What are you doing the day of the race?
What are you doing the day of the race, John Millard?
Well, you come down, you know, your boat weighs in. Scotty
just
drove it down. You took it. You take your equipment out so you can make the weight. I don't know if they still do that.
Yeah, they're not weighing it with it in.
All right, so then you tie it in, and every racer has their own way of, like, preparing not to be nervous.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, John, you put a lot of work leading up to this race. These guys put a lot of time and effort. You don't just hop in a boat, Scotty McKay, and start rowing, do you?
No, not at all. It's not. It seems like it would be easy and fun until you get in.
No, but I remember the one time that Scotty and Tom Molina were setting the flags. He was the old chief, and they challenged us to, like, you know, a little race. We were out there.
Blow them out of the water, John.
Yeah, and we're gonna beat your butts.
And then
they lasted about 45 seconds.
Yeah, right.
We're broadcasting live from Longport for the South Jersey Lifeguard Champions. We're talking with a former champion, John Millar. Of course, his partner was John Ridgway of Ocean City. Ron Kirk won the singles that year, and James Kegley won the swim, but Ocean City,
Jimmy Kegley.
And he ended up winning the race. And then you bring it home to your home beach. That's got to be pretty exciting to have the event, John, after you guys win, to bring it back home to Ocean City.
Well, one thing you look at, Billy, is, you know, you have a meeting, you pick your lane, you look at your flag, and if you noticed, some guys are ankle deep.
Yeah.
And other guys are like up to the chest on the start.
John, how much did you use? I mean, you see a lot of the teams, they have flags up that they use to get you to steer, to get you on course there. How much did you use that when you were rowing?
All my old alumni.
Right.
So we stuck with our plan.
Right.
Like we were the ones together. When you row with a partner, you become very close. You know, it's just you and him.
Well, you
got
to work in unison. I mean, you got to be pulling together. If you're not on the same page, it probably makes it pretty difficult.
Somebody's back's getting banged up.
Yeah.
If you're not.
But I'm just telling you, like, what lane you get makes a big difference.
Especially when the conditions. Now, John, you rode in all kind of seas, flat and big waves. You guys, I guess as a crew, you probably like rowing in some big waves because you can catch a nice wave coming in.
Our biggest argument was, you know, John, like, it's too rough to row tonight.
Right.
And I say, would they have a race tonight? And yes, they would. So
you don't get to pick your conditions.
Yes, sure, you got to go out there. So that's ocean rowing. Like, you never know what you're going to get.
Yeah.
And John, we want to thank you so much for being a sponsor of this race and getting it on the air. Without your support and contribution to the race,
we wouldn't be able to do that.
Well, I do, because it's very important that we let our listeners know that you're a big sponsor of the races. And without your support, we wouldn't be able to make this broadcast. And I know, John, I've gotten emails and text messages from people that I haven't talked to in years that haven't been able to make it down here and have been able to listen to the broadcast from as far away as California and even in a hospital bed in Philadelphia. So, John, we really appreciate it, man.
Well, can I say one more thing before
I exit?
I do respect, like, the older guys that row and continue to win every year, but I would like to see younger guys.
Yeah, you know, nowadays
I had to beat Ron Kirk to get out of town.
Yeah, right.
That's not an easy task.
No, and Scooter knows that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And, you know, don't ever doubt yourself, and, you know, here's the thing, Bill. If you went to high school and never played a sport, would your experience be the same?
No, because sports, athletics prepare you for life.
Yeah, my best
memories.
Class was after school, you know, rowing for Stan Bergman, who's a
sure. Yeah, absolutely,
legend.
Stan. He's a legend.
He taught
me,
he was my second dad. And I know he's from Ventnor.
Well,
but
John, well, listen, we really appreciate you taking time to come up here. We wanted to thank you for being a part of the broadcast and sponsoring the race. We want to take a break now and get some business out of the way before the racers turn the flag. Do you have a quick update on the
race
out there, Dan?
It's a tight race out there. You got five or six crews that are in the hunt. You got
That's
Margate,
what we like to see.
You got Margate, you got Ventnor, you got Avalon, you got Longport, and you got Atlantic City all in the hunt. They're
That's
all
great.
Tight, and it's all close.
All right, 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships brought to you by Mcgann Realtors of Seattle City, a family tradition since 1939, 4111 Atlantis Avenue in Seattle. Home sale, summer rentals, 609-263-7422. And by Blitz's Markets in Ocean City, New Jersey. Order online. Blitz's Market are located at 21st and 34th Street on Asbury Avenue in Ocean City, 609-399-9983. Blitz's, home of the dill pickle hoagie. It's really a big dill. And by Famous Dino's Subs and Pizza of Margate, 8016 Ventnor Avenue in Margate. Dine in or take out, 609-822-6602. Let's go, Margate. All right, when we return, we'll have the doubles crews coming back. You're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championship races. Saturday morning in the locker room with Billy Schweim, the Phillies and the Reds hook up for a three-game set. Can they hold on to the lead in the NL East? We will recap Game 1. Former Phillies manager of the 2008 World Series championship team, Charlie Manuel, joins us to talk about the Phillies retiring Roy Halladay's number 34. The Eagles played the Steelers Thursday night in South Philly, and we will review the first preseason action. It's the locker room with Billy Schweim, Saturday morning from 10 a.m. to noon on 97.3 ESPN.
Health update with Robin Stoloff. Learn more, live better.
If you have a teenager, you wouldn't be surprised that a recent study found that almost 95% of them are spending more time on screens and tech and not getting enough sleep or exercise. All three of these behaviors have been linked to negative consequences for the health of our kids, including increased risk of depression, poor school performance, and obesity. It's recommended that teens get between 8 and 10 hours of sleep per night and 1 hour of vigorous physical activity each day. What can we do? Well, we can start by setting an example and making fitness and sleep a priority in our own lives. We can set parameters such as a nightly bedtime and make it a family goal. We can work together to limit screen time and be active together as a family. I'm Robin Stoloff for Health Update.
Health Update with Robin Stoloff, empowering you to live a healthier life.
On some models, excludes Corvette with GM financing, excludes price sale. See dealer for details.
Have you seen what some dealers are now charging for new cars and used vehicles? It's outrageous. But at Bennett Chevrolet, you still pay what GM supplier employees pay for brand new Chevys. Plus, Bennett gives you all the rebates. That's not either or. You get both. And that can save you up to 25% off MSRP. And Bennett has 0% financing available to save you even more. Got a trade? Bennett's paying top dollar. And we mean top dollar. A minimum $7,000 towards any pre-owned in stock. That's a minimum $7,000 for any old clunker you can tow to our lot. And if it's in good shape, we'll pay more. And we'll buy your vehicle even if you don't buy one of ours. And Bennett makes it so easy. No sales pressure, no negotiating, just pure joy. Because our non-commissioned sales staff is paid on your satisfaction, not how much you spend. So you can see why nobody beats Bennett Chevrolet. Nobody. Find new roads at Bennett Chevy, Egg Harbor Township, and BennettChevy.com.
Hey, it's Mike Gill from The Sports Batch. If you're an advertising salesperson, how would you like to sell my show, The Sports Batch, here at 97.3 ESPN and Town Square Media? We're hiring new advertising salespeople to sell The Sports Batch, the number one sports talk show in all of South Jersey at the number one media company in South Jersey. Selling the Sports Batch is the job that will take you as far as you want to go. An excellent compensation package awaits you, as does a creative and fun working environment. So join the team on the Sports Batch and Town Square Media. It's truly the most advanced media company in all of South Jersey. Start or build upon your sales career by becoming a member of our team here at 97.3 ESPN and Town Square Media. If you're interested, apply at townsquaremedia.com. Click on careers. Town Square Media is an equal opportunity employer.
All right, welcome back to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. Brought to you by 7th and 11th Street Bike and Surrey Rentals, located at the Boardwalk in Ocean City, open 7 days a week from 7:30 a.m. to 12 noon. In business for 30 years. Enjoy riding the Ocean City Boardwalk on great bikes, friendly service, 609-425-5169, and by Leeds Builders, 30 years of building beautiful custom homes. Are you ready for your beautiful house by the sea? Call Leeds Builders, 609-822-4506. And Dan Adams, you got an update.
Yeah, that's correct, Billy. We did get an update here. Coming into the singles flags, we got Margate out by about a boat over Ventnor, followed by Sea Isle, followed by Longport, followed by Wildwood Crest. But us looking here, it looks like they're a lot tighter than what we can see.
Well, if you notice, the Margate boat is far to the north. Looks like everybody, the wind is out of the south-southeast. A lot of these boats are coming in straight, but it looks like Margate,
and Longport.
It looks like Atlantic City is really off behind, and a few other of the boats, I
remember,
can't make out.
They were in one and two.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were.
Know, they're going to be the most northern boats typically.
But I got to tell you that we're looking at straight ahead of us, it could be Ventnor and Cape May. But you have Ventnor, you have Margate, Ventnor, and Sea Isle.
Longport, Wildwood Crest, yeah.
All right, we got John Malar, winner of the 86 doubles in the South Jersey Championships. What are the racers going through right now, John?
Well, I'm looking at the boats drifting.
Is that a strategy, John? I mean, they letting the wind and the current take them?
No, it's the boats that are beating up wind and that are, you know, it's the boats to your right. Yeah. I would watch.
Dan Adams, it looks like whoever is right in front of us, we can't make it out, but these three boats are neck and neck. And to me, they are, you know, shortest distance scooter from one point to another point is a straight line. And looks like this could be Ventnor in front of us.
Yeah, that's Ventnor and Sea Isle most likely right near in front of us and near and far and close. So, and then, you know.
Sea Isle City is Danny Rogers and Pat Scampico. And these guys have been in the mix. I got a feeling, I'm looking at, by the way, Margate and Longport are far to the north.
Far to the north. It looks like right now Ventnor's right in the hunt too. Ventnor's right here.
Whoever
in the front
this boat
here.
Is to the last boat, the most southern boat, they look like they're close.
That could be Sea Isle.
That could be Sea Isle. We can't make it out, but I'll tell you what.
14, so
a lot of the Sea Isle cards.
Now Billy.
Margate just got on right here. Run.
Margate did get on
a little wave right there.
Ventnor's got a wave coming
behind
them.
Wow, this is going to be close. We're going to have to stand up for this call. By the way, look at the crowd on this beach. It is phenomenal. There's got to be at least 3,000 people on this beach.
Margate's getting on another wave. They're close to the boundary,
I'll tell you what.
Yeah, they're tight.
You know what? Margate looks like they're pulling it.
Margate's ahead right now. There's
no
doubt about it.
You're pulling a lot of lefts at this point.
Margate is definitely winning.
Ventnor City's going to get on a little bit of a wave.
Seattle's got a wave right here.
Seattle's right in front of us.
Sea Isle's got a wave.
Looks like Margate just came in.
Sea Isle's on a wave, and they are not
Margate.
Stopping. Longport's on a wave.
Wow, it's going to be close. We're not going to be able to tell.
Well, I can see it. You're going to see Margate cross the line here in a second. Margate just won that
Margate
race.
Margate just won the race. Looks like
Sea Isle second.
Longport
Sea
or Sea Isle.
Sea Isle gets a second.
And Longport probably third, followed by Ventnor fourth.
Wow.
How about
And Atlantic City to the north. Looks like they might get a... Although Wildwood Crest just got on a wave. How about Avalon?
Atlantic City might be out of the boundaries. I don't know. I can't tell from here, but they look like they're on the outside of that stand.
Here comes Wildwood Crest.
Wildwood
making
Crest
a strong
is
finish.
Probably finish that. Is that the fifth boat to finish?
Wildwood Crest. What a race for those guys.
And Atlantic City did finish
That's
in the boundaries.
That's Terry McGovern and Derek Komorowski.
Atlantic City sixth. And then it's looks like who was the red boat down there?
Can't tell.
What
a race!
Might have been
North Wildwood.
Could have been, yeah.
It might have been North Wildwood.
Stone Harbor just finished. Still got
the once proud Ocean City boat is really picking up the rear there, Scotty McKay, your former Beach Patrol.
There's always got to be a caboose.
I'll tell you what, man, they're shell of what they used to be.
Think about who they are, though. They are part of legendary rowers over there.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, Ron Kirk and Oves were both great rowers for Ocean City and had a lot of great years. Sure. A lot of good competitions from them.
A great showing by Sea Isle City
tonight.
So,
unofficial, we got Margate first. We got Sea Isle, Longport, close second, third. We don't have an official ruling. And then who do we have fourth there again?
Who do you think?
Ventnor. Ventnor was fourth.
Ventnor was fourth.
Yep.
And it looks like maybe Wildwood Crest looks
so,
like they got a fifth.
Unofficial. And this is just from our standpoint.
Yeah.
Unofficial, we got Margate, Sea Isle, Longport, Ventnor, Wildwood Crest.
Now, first place gets 5 points, Dan. Second place gets 4 points. Third place gets 3 points. Fourth place gets 2 points. And fifth place gets 1 point. So not necessarily you have to finish first in every race, but you have to, as a Beach Patrol, at least score in every race.
And that's correct. And that's what Longport did in their first South Jersey Championship.
Which I got to say, Dan, that was probably one of the most exciting finishes that I've seen in some time.
And
the emotion that you guys displayed was like it culminated like a relief, exuberation, jubilation. You name the adjective, it was that. I'll never forget it.
Absolutely. And as we're standing here, we could reach out and touch the swimmers right now. They're getting through their lineup to make sure everybody's here. They're running through the numbers. But what a great race. And hey, Chris Graves, Chuck Gowdy. Chuck Gowdy is definitely one of the greatest rowers of all time.
I think he just got his 12th.
He just got his 12th win.
You know, no doubt.
And, you know, he hasn't been racing this year.
Was his first race all season.
Wow.
Well, we want to thank John Malar for being in. John Malar for being here and helping us call a little bit of the action. Now I'd like to welcome in former chief of the Sea Isle Beach Patrol, Tom Mcgann. What's up, Tom?
Billy, hey, thanks for having me.
Man, I'll tell you what a great finish. You know, you get to see what these guys are all made about.
Yeah.
The passion that they bring.
Great finish. Phenomenal finish. Like Dan said, one of the best ever.
You got to get that Hall of Fame going there, Tom.
Yeah, I'm waiting for Chief Adams to get going on it. And I'm going to join the squad.
So we're waiting for the swim as we have all the swimmers. Literally, we are right here, Scotty McKay.
We're on top of it. Hopefully the tide stays right where it's at.
Yeah, I think it'll stay there.
We got a big group of swimmers right in front of us, man, getting ready to go. The horn's going to set pretty soon.
And I just went through the records and just double-checked. This would be Chuck Gowdy's 13th South
13th?
Jersey Championship.
Okay.
He has 11 doubles title. Well, this would be his 12th doubles
title.
Here
we go. We're getting ready for the swim. There goes
go.
Horn.
And one singles title.
Wow. We got two girls
two
in this
women.
Race.
Absolutely. It's great.
And look, like I said to you, and I say it every week, Joey Tepper starts out in the back. He's not running up in front of the field. He's not getting out in front. But watch him just move through the water. He's already moved past four people. He's right in the middle, right smack in the center of the course.
What hat is he wearing? What color?
He's wearing
hat?
That orange cap
the
with
orange
the,
cap?
The white tee on it for
okay.
Tennessee.
Right.
But now they're hitting the sandbar.
Looks like they're hitting a sandbar right
but
there.
But they're not stopping. Most of them are going to just keep swimming. Swimming
Joey,
right through
Joey
it.
Could probably walk another 50 yards.
Yeah, Joey's still, he's getting up. He's doing a little dolphin now. It looks like Joey and Grisbaum are out there in front. There is one person to the far, to the south side that might be out on him a little bit.
Let's look at some of the racers, too. Atlantic City, John Saul. Dolan Grisbaum of Avalon's really been on Joey Tepper's tail. Andy Thomas from Brigantine, Cape May. Kate Luff, no entry for Cape May Point. Longport, of course, Joey Tepper. Margate, Zach Vassar. North Wildwood, Molly Cowell. Ocean City, Billy McGuire. Seattle City, Corbin King, Stone Harbor, Jack Lavari, Upper Township, Lindsey Robbins, Vendor, Mike McKinnon. Did I say that name right, Dan?
McMenamin.
Mike McMenamin.
Okay. And then Wildwood, Brandon Lewis, and then Wildwood Crest, Brett Peterson. A pretty tough field, but they're all chasing Joey Tepper.
They are chasing Joey Tepper. You look at the last two wins, though. They weren't his normal wins by a wide
right.
margin. He the field has definitely closed the gap on Joey. They're definitely giving him a hunt and giving him a race. But that's what makes this race even more important, and that's what makes it even better, that the competitors are all tough, and it just shows you that each beach patrol can put a tough field out there. And here we are. Hey, Zach Vassar finishes third. Margate's looking at 8 points going into the singles.
Yeah,
that's right.
That's a
strong spot. You don't have those extra races in this race to do it. Tom, how much pushing and grabbing and tugging's going on out there right now?
I tell you, you have to be a tough nut swimming these ocean races.
Right?
Yeah.
And Dan's talking about the competitiveness and the athleticism. What's really great about this is these guys peak for this race. So you're going to see the fastest times today. They're at their best. They tapered.
Yep.
They're ready to go. And they're outstanding athletes. And that's why they can do this. They're not in a pool here.
Right.
They're in the ocean.
This is for real. Hey, what a great crowd we have here, too, Scotty McKay.
Yeah,
Dan
it's
Adams.
Jammed, man.
What, this beach is packed with a ton of fans, ton of supporters, and probably a lot of alumni, Tom. We said last week how this is not only a big sporting event, but it's also a reunion of sorts. A lot of the beach patrols have their reunions this weekend.
Absolutely, because there's so many people in town, that's the time to do it.
I'm looking at this crowd right now, and I always thought Margate's put a bigger crowd out, but I think tonight might be the biggest crowd. When you look to the north side especially, there's no room to
even
right. move. The crowd is unbelievable. It's packed house here, and what a great night for racing. Beautiful conditions.
Beautiful.
Clear, so everybody can see what's going on. And so far, we've had a great race in the doubles, and here we are in the swim, and it's going to be another
and
great
it's a,
race.
And look, anything can happen right now with the scoring. Especially when Margate wins the doubles. Duffy and Mcgrath have been perennial winners. Now this puts a little monkey wrench in Longport's plans. Obviously, Joey Tepper coming in first will change all that.
Yeah, if Joey comes in first, if we follow the top three the way it's been and Joey comes in first, Margate and Longport will be tied with 8 points going into the singles, and then it's going to be a battle. And we talked about it. You got eight people rowing both events tonight in the singles. It's going to come down to a dogfight. It's going to be that last rower standing. and we'll see who it is.
And both Margate and Longport have one of their double crews rowing singles. So they're going to both, it's not like one's fresh and the other
right,
one's
there's, well, there's eight of them.
Right, but I mean those two, when they're battling for probably first place, they're going to be the ones saying, hey, I got to give them the extra now, and I might not have much left.
But, Tommy, you know, the excitement, these guys expend so much energy. When they come back in, they got to be spent.
Right, and absolutely. And I don't know how. Remember years ago, a couple years ago, Dan, when Trippishin got out of the doubles and stepped in, won the doubles with David Funk and stepped into the swim, right out of the boat, into the swim,
wow,
and took third in the swim.
Wow. And that's you hit a key point there.
Yeah.
It's all about scoring in every event. You have to score in every event to win the South Jersey Championships. If you don't score in all three events, you're not going to win.
Right.
Tommy, I want to first off, I want to thank you so much, the Mcgann family, Mcgann Realtors, you guys with John Malar, great sponsors.
Yeah.
You guys help us. And if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be able to broadcast these races. So first of all, I want to thank you and the Mcgann family for being contributors and sponsors to the race.
Yeah, we're happy to do it. My brother John was captain of Wildwood for 10 years, and he was always intimately involved with the races, participating with the races, getting the alumni involved in the judging part to keep everybody intact. He runs his business that way, and we're proud of what he does, and we're proud of our lifeguards from Brigantine to Cape May Point.
I know John Malar and the Mcgann family. When you get on the beach here and see the people on the beach supporting this, it gives you satisfaction. You know, it's such a big event.
Yeah, I mean,
it's a tradition in South Jersey.
Their family, the Mcganns, have been huge in this for years. I mean, I remember dealing with John with the races.
Yeah.
And, you know, going down.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's great because, just like I said, to see the alumni, Ocean City's having their reunion tomorrow night, I think, so it's a great time for
everybody. Well, you see, if you look at the tonight's race, several years ago, Malar and Ridgeway won this race.
Yes.
And they were a crew to deal with from Ocean City.
Yep.
They were a real problem for us.
Remember, I think I remember them lifting you guys up. You guys sat in the boat, and the beach patrol literally lifted the boat up with you guys in it.
Right.
Yeah.
Seemed like that way. Do you have any update on the swim?
I got nothing right now. I'm going to see what I can find out, but nothing as
of
right now.
You know, it wouldn't be a bad idea for the future in some of this, that the hosting event, they give out colored caps that for each competitor.
Yeah, that would be a bad idea.
15 different colors.
And, it would be a bad idea.
And then you could kind of give a little bit better idea instead of having them wear their own caps.
Scott, how good is your eyesight? Would you be able to see that
swim flag? No, but there's got to be somebody out there that could be telling us something.
Well, we're going to try and get that now. I'm going to see what I can find out, and we'll see what we can find out here.
Now, if you haven't had a chance to get down to one of these events, you make sure you get it put on your calendar in the future because, hey, it's Friday, August 13th, middle of August. Just a hot, steamy day today. Perfect day for racing and a little cloud cover coming in from the south. But what a beautiful night for racing, Tom.
Well, you know, and it's very true. And one of the guys that I admired the most over the years in the swimming was Tommy Swift.
Yeah.
When he won 6 South Jersey titles, 5 in a row, and matching what Dick Thieler did from Ocean City. 6 South Jersey titles, 5 in a row. To be at that level of competition for that long period of time is amazing. Because your competition guys from other beach patrols are all rowing and swimming for colleges and working out all year for this.
And we just got finished the Olympics. And some of these swimmers have actually participated in the trials and almost represented the United States in the Olympics.
Right.
Absolutely. Years ago for Ocean City, Timmy McKee.
Yeah.
And he just passed away, by the way, about 3 months ago. Uh-huh. But he swam in the Olympics, and his brother Kevin, or actually Kevin just passed away about a month and a half ago. But he was on our beach patrol at Ocean City, but Timmy was an Olympic swimmer.
He got second in the jerseys.
Yeah.
We got a great crowd here in Longport, New Jersey for the South Jersey Lifeguard Champs. The 81st, Tom. 81st, 1924 this race started.
Yes.
Were you there the first one, Tom?
I was there. My stand partner was McKay.
Yeah, right. Exactly. What a team.
Two Irish guys stuck on the north end, South Carolina.
What was
Avenue.
In that cooler?
You don't want to talk about it.
Right.
Yeah. Now, they started the South Jerseys on South Carolina Avenue in Atlantic City back in 1924. The chief wanted to get his guys ready for rescues. So he had races with two old beach patrols, Wildwood and Cape May.
Wow.
Yeah, back in the early 20s. But he started out racing himself.
Tom, you are an historian, and you have written books
yes.
on the history of the, of the of these races.
Yes, I have.
Yeah. And so tell us a little bit more about the Margates. They didn't start till...
They started in 1946 in the Margates, and that's a day that it was a really interesting piece of history in Margates, the first race.
Because this was the 75th annual last week.
1946, Whitey Thomas and Joe Herron won the Margates in the doubles because they caught a wave about 100 yards off the beach, and they won by 50 seconds. And then Boomer Blair caught a wave in the singles, and there was only a doubles and a singles, Lank City and Ventnor at that time.
All right, you're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. When we get back, we'll have the swimmers coming in. We'll get the call for you. Stay tuned for more action right here from the beach in Longport, New Jersey.
Home of the Eagles, Sixers, and Flyers. WENJ, WENJ HD, Millville, Atlantic City, 97.3 ESPN.
Tonight on Compass Media Network's coverage of the NFL. The 2021 season gets underway as the Cowboys and Cardinals kick off the preseason from Arizona. Hi, this is Jerry Recco. Join Kevin Ray, Danny White, and myself for all the action as the Cowboys square off with Kyler Murray and the Cardinals. Football is back. It's the Dallas Cowboys and the Arizona Cardinals. If it's the NFL, it's right here.
Coverage begins at 9:30 on 97.3 ESPN.
On some models, excludes core bet with GM financing, excludes price. See dealer for details.
Have you seen what some dealers are now charging for new cars and used vehicles? It's outrageous. But at Bennett Chevrolet, you still pay what GM supplier employees pay for brand new Chevys. Plus, Bennett gives you all the rebates. That's not either or. You get both. And that can save you up to 25% off MSRP. And Bennett has 0% financing available to save you even more. Got a trade? Bennett's paying top dollar, and we mean top dollar. A minimum $7,000 towards any pre-owned in stock. That's a minimum $7,000 for any old clunker you can tow to our lot. And if it's in good shape, we'll pay more. And we'll buy your vehicle even if you don't buy one of ours. And Bennett makes it so easy. No sales pressure, no negotiating, just pure joy. Because our non-commissioned sales staff is paid on your satisfaction. Faction, not how much you spend. So you can see why nobody beats Bennett Chevrolet. Nobody. Find new roads at Bennett Chevy, Egg Harbor Township, and BennettChevy.com.
Football season is about to kick off, and that means it's time to list your football future bets on PropSwap. Did you know before the season started last year, the Buccaneers were 60-1 to win it all? Now that's a futures bet. You just never know what can happen. Or hey, maybe you do. Sports bettors cash in early and often when they list long shots on PropSwap. The average monthly seller makes $500 a month on PropSwap just posting and selling tickets. So join them by going to PropSwap.com or download the PropSwap app today. PropSwap, where America buys and sells sports. Bets.
When you support your local small businesses, it helps keep your neighbors employed, helps kids save for college, and strengthens your community. And Town Square Media South Jersey puts local businesses in the spotlight.
Ambient Comfort Heating and Cooling Professionals. AmbientComfortNJ.com.
Filling Marble and Tile Outlet, Philadelphia Avenue and Route 30 in Egg Harbor City. FillingMarble.com.
Dennisville Fence, serving you since 1952. Be the envy of your neighborhood.
Comfort Now by Bob McAllister. Improve the comfort in your home. Call 609-400-1005 and ask about discounts and rebate incentives. Visit IWantComfortNow.com.
East Coast Roofing, Siding and Windows, services all of South Jersey. If you call, they'll show up. Call East Coast today at 609-646-1444. Online at eastcoastroofing.com.
Thank you for supporting your local businesses. From Town Square Media, South Jersey.
It's summer in the Garden State. Now's the time to get sweet Jersey Fresh peaches and nectarines. I'm New Jersey Secretary of Agriculture Doug Fisher reminding you to enjoy these Jersey Fresh gems. Find Jersey Fresh peaches today at your favorite market. Stay loyal to local, Jersey Fresh.
We're back here for 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. We're in the middle of the swim, and Dan, you got an update on who's ahead?
I did. At the turn, we had Longport, Joey Tepper, Avalon, Dolan Grisbound in second, Margate, Zach Vassar in third, We had Brendan Lewis from Wildwood in fourth, and we had Brett Peterson from Wildwood Crest in fifth.
The usual suspects.
Get down for a minute.
The usual suspects are winning the race. Tom Mcgann is joining us. And Tommy, you're a bit of an historian. You written some books on the races, and the singles didn't start until 1973, the singles race.
Yeah, and it wasn't with great enthusiasm across the board. The old traditional guys wanted to keep a swim and the doubles. The doubles is the standard bearer.
Right.
And then they brought the swim in 1946 in the South Jerseys. But that was with a lot of kicking and screaming. 1973, they finally put the singles in the South Jerseys.
And I think it makes it for a great race, having a singles, doubles, and the swim.
It's beautiful. It's a nice balance. It's good scoring.
And it looks like Joey Tepper is...
He's ahead by about 25 yards. You got Dolan Grimsbaum. He's swimming a little better course. Joey's a little to the north, but he is ahead by about 25 yards.
Now, I can make out that orange cap from here.
Yeah.
And you can see Dolan Grimsbaum's yellow cap from here as well.
Just Joey Tepper, he's something special to watch, Dan Adams.
He is, and we talked about it, and we'll say it again. He has a body for ocean swimming. He's long and lanky and lean. His body gets up on top of that water, and he just goes. And to watch it from an aerial view, it's pretty amazing to see his body.
Look, he literally stopped. He got up. He stopped swimming. He's waiting for a wave. That's how far ahead he is.
Well, he better watch
this guy
it.
Right here.
Oh, Dolan Grimsbaum
is right here.
Catch his wave.
He better get
Tepper
moving.
Might have made a mistake.
He
could have made a big mistake,
lax, but I think he's still far enough.
Yeah,
ahead.
But he's got to come right here. I don't
you
know.
That. You got that.
I don't know.
You got that, Gully.
Oh my gosh.
He's got it.
No,
he's
got
to come right to here, though.
This guy could do it.
This guy could do it right here.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
Catches a little bit.
Joey Tepper could be upset. Dolan Grimsbaum is making a push. Tepper's out of the water. So is Dolan Grimsbaum. Looks like Tepper's going to win this.
Come on, Tepper. Here we go. It's going to be tighter than you think, though. This is a lot tighter. And it just shows you that anything can happen on any given race.
Beautiful.
What a race.
Joey Tepper.
He's not even breathing.
I'll tell you what, you guys. Joey Tepper almost made a critical mistake.
He did. He got up. He stood up and kind of relaxed for a second.
Right.
But he still won, and he's still the 2021 South Jersey champion.
Where's he guard at?
I think it's Longport Beach Patrol, some town that maybe we're sitting here.
Yeah, right.
Joey,
I believe we got a couple guys coming in.
Let's see if this is Zach Vassar from Margate.
That could be a big difference if Vassar gets third here.
Well, Vassar gets third. We got a tie, and the tiebreaker going into the final event.
Doesn't look like he's pushing too hard, though. Got a guy right here. What's this guy's?
No, that's this.
Maybe that's a.
He doesn't have a cap on, Scooter.
All right. Well, he might be capless.
This looks like it's Zach Vassar from Margate. We'll know here in a second.
Catches a little wave with the inside break.
There you go.
Gets out of the water.
That is Zach Vassar.
Right, he doesn't have a cap on.
That is Margate. Zach Vassar, third
Vassar.
Place. So, you know, let's look at the score right now. You got 8 points with Margate in the lead. They won the double, so traditional South Jersey rules. If the race were to end right now, they win. They win the tiebreaker.
Yep.
Longport with 8 points going into the singles, and it's going to come down to a dogfight in that singles. It's going to come down to those eight rowers, and we talked about it. There's five or six that can win this event.
Who got second in the doubles? Was it Cio?
Cio was second in the doubles. That is confirmed.
Yeah.
So, hey, Dan, or Tom, either one of you. Do you think the fact that, like you just alluded to earlier, that Chuck Gowdy, this was his first race of the year, do you think the layoff will help him in the singles and give him a little bit of a break? Or do you think, that's going to be Mcgrath is going to have, being rowing every day, he's going to have the advantage?
That's going to be a tough call. That's going to be a tough edge. And you can't, you know what, Scott, you can't take anything away from Chuck Gowdy.
No. We got some racers coming in right here.
Here we go. We got Wildwood Crest.
Wildwood.
Fourth. Wildwood Crest came out and got that fourth.
That's
over Wildwood.
Brett Peterson getting a fourth here in a swim. Good work for him.
Yeah.
He's been in the
mix.
And you can hear the crowd. I'll tell you what a great crowd. This place is packed. As far as you can see. And I would say, Scooter, it's a very good-looking crowd.
It's a... the South is beating the North here in a lot of ways.
It is summertime.
It's good to be
South
up in the air.
Yeah.
on the stage.
It is summertime in South Jersey.
It's beautiful.
You know what's funny when you think about it? This guy shouldn't have wore his tank top as much so far. But the back in the day when Sid Cassidy swam for Ocean City, he was kind of a heavier set guy.
He had a stockier build,
lean like these guys. And I think that he was more buoyant in some senses, and the salt makes him more buoyant. Yeah. And he would come in and crack a beer before the second guy came in.
he was out there. That guy was fast.
He was tough.
So scoring going into the final event right now. You got Margate and Longport with 8 points.
Wow.
You got Sea Isle and Avalon with 4 points. You got Wildwood Crest with 3. You got Ventnor with 2.
So it's going to come down. It's going to come down to the singles between Mike Mcgrath and Chuck Gowdy.
Yep. Again,
how appropriate
and
is that?
Mike has to place one place in front of Chuck Gowdy.
Yeah.
And this happened, the same thing happened in Sea Isle.
Right.
Going into that final race, Mike had to beat Gowdy by one position. He couldn't let Gowdy beat him. So here we are in the same similar situation. Flash forward 5 years later, and here we are. We're looking at the same situation, same potential outcome. But, hey, we can't count out David Funk winning that race.
Right.
But it boils down to those two competitors. They could finish first through fifth, but in order for Longport to win, they have to be one place ahead of.
I'm surprised at
Margate.
I'm surprised at Atlantic City's crew tonight. Usually get a better showing from Vince Granese and Kyle Deroo.
They finished sixth.
They finished sixth, but not good enough
The course was a little off. There's no doubt about that. We talked about that coming in. They had to make adjustment to finish.
Plus,
in the
Vince Granese. We talked about this early, you guys. Vince Granese, Erich Wolf, Mike Mcgrath, Chuck Gowdy, Danny Rodgers, several David Funk, and Derek Kobarowski. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 guys doubling up.
That's the new normal.
Yeah, that's the new normal.
Yeah. And I remember when Mike Solinsky did that for the first time in the Margates back in the 70s, and everybody thought they called him Iron Man Mike because he got in the doubles and the singles. And he performed well and got a first and a second.
Look, it's not easy. It can't be easy for these guys. And, you know, these guys are in tip-top shape, Tom.
Sure, absolutely are.
And we're waiting for a couple swimmers to come in. But as soon as the swimmers come in, Scooter, the singles will take off.
Yeah.
And then we'll be off to the races. Here comes, I want to say this could be Lindsay Robbins. I'm not sure.
Could be.
It's Upper Township.
Upper Township. It is. Yes, it is.
Lindsay Robbins.
Robbins just came in. I think there's one more swimmer out in the water. Might it be?
It could be Bobby Schweim. Still out in the water.
It could be Mike. We got one more. We do have one more swimmer coming in, and then we'll have the singles race.
Are you done with me?
The singles race will be momentarily as we're waiting for one more swimmer to come in. And you look at some of these swimmers, Scotty McKay, Vince Granese, Erich Wolf, Mike Mcgrath, Chuck Gowdy, and David Funk, Derek Kobarowski, all but one, Scooter, are experienced guys that have been around for a long, long time.
Yeah, and these kind of races, experience is going to be crucial for these things.
Yeah.
Luckily, the surf's not, like, too crazy tonight, but you got to keep your eye, you know?
That bar break is beautiful.
Yeah.
If there could be a wave here. Swimmer, it looks like we're waiting on Mike McMenamin, who finished last week.
Yep.
What a great kid, though. What a great competitor.
The only singles participant is Danny Rodgers, and he's fairly young compared to the competition tonight, Dan Adams.
We talked about it. Derek Kobarowski's been around for a long time. Dave Funk talked about rowing. He started rowing in these races 1996, 1997.
And he won the Margates last week.
And he did win the Margates. Chuck Gowdy's been rowing for a long time. Mike McGrath's been rowing for 16 years together with Sean Duffy. And then he rowed with his dad a couple years before that.
And here comes
Mike McMenamin.
Mike McMenamin, dead
Mike,
last again.
Job.
Guess what? He finished.
That's right. He's in there.
He beat Cape May Point. They didn't have a swimmer.
Think about what we talked about with Mike McMenamin. He's the best of what Ventnor could put out here. And he comes out and he goes out strong and he does the best he can to represent
with enthusiasm. Yes.
And he's still a city champion. His name still goes on the plaque at headquarters as city champion.
He was pumping the crowd up as he came in. Yeah. Love it, you know.
Hey, you know, my name's only on that plaque four times in Beach headquarters, but I'll take those four city championships that I got and relish in that.
Take it in pride.
It's a great feeling. It's a great thing. And you know what? What a great night for racing. Let's go. We're getting
all right, let's set the stage, Tom Scooter and Dan Adams. What, we couldn't ask for a better finish where we have Margate and Longport tied at eight, and it comes down to the last race.
Down to
two singles rowers here.
This is a rerun of 2016 in Avalon. We're in the same exact situation as far as points and scoring, and it was the same situation there. Mike Mcgrath knew going into that singles race that he had to finish one place better than Chuck Gowdy.
Right.
And here we are.
And the singles rowers are all at the water's edge. They're all getting themselves in. And Scooter, talk to us a little bit about the tow board. It's a piece of equipment that's pretty much homemade.
Yeah, these guys make these things. There's a the distance between the bow seat and the stern seat is a little bit longer than most guys' legs. And so they put a tow board in there, which has hoops in it where you can put your feet in, and it kind of gives you that bounce. They also have the seats they put on there, and they lubricate them a little bit so they can slide kind of like a crew team would slide on the boat.
But think about that. That's changed over time, too. We used to have sheet extensions over the seat. The seat can't be any wider than the width of the rowing seat that's in there.
Right.
So you take a disadvantage to a tall guy, that's not the same advantage as someone who might be a little shorter.
All right, the red flag is looks like it's getting ready to go up here.
That was the two-minute warning.
That's the two-minute warning. Okay.
Scott, we're going to give my man, you talked about it earlier, we're going to give my man Brian Mann, B38, longtime Longport Beach Patrol member. He's been on for this is 26th season working with the Beach Patrol. So, you know, we'll give a shout-out right now to Brian, B38, Brian Mann.
Absolutely.
Good job, Brian.
I met him out at Caroline's one night, and just a great guy. He had the shirt on, Lieutenant. Yeah. That was great. So he's cheering everybody on here.
All right, so he's a true inspiration to the Beach Patrol and all of us. So
Dan,
go ahead.
What are the let's give us a rundown from south to north the beach the lanes here. What do we got?
All right, so we got going from the south. We got lane 15 is Wildwood Crest. Lane 14 Sea Isle. Lane 13 Vetner.
The Sea Isle. You want to watch the Sea Isle rower, Danny Rogers, a young kid. That's been very competitive.
And you got to watch lane 13.
He's doing well.
You got to watch lane 13, Dave Funk. Lane 12, Ocean City. Lane 11, North Wildwood. Lane 10 is Stone Harbor. Lane 9 is Cape May. Lane 8 is, where am I drawing a blank?
Upper
lane
8, Township.
Upper Township. Lane 7, Avalon. Eric Wolf.
Eric
Wolf. Competitor.
Another perennial
lane
favorite.
Lane 6, Cape May Point. Ben Swan.
Ben Swan, who won the Dutch.
Cape May Counties.
Yep, the Cape May Counties.
Lane 5.
Brigantine.
Ron DeFelice, strong showing in both of his races. Lane 4.
The flag is up.
Wildwood. Lane 3. Atlantic City, Vince Granese. Lane 2, Margate, Chuck Gowdy. And lane 1, Mike Mcgrath in Longport.
I got to tell you, I think David Funk probably has the inside track to win it. He won the Margates last week. And, you know, I mean.
He does. But we do have a nice little break on the sandbar. So I think it's going to come down to someone getting one of those waves and riding it to the beach.
And this is.
There we go.
Here it goes.
They're
off.
It starts and turns here, man. It starts and turns.
Turns and finish.
Yep.
All right. So we got Mike Mcgrath got a great start there. He's in the boat quick.
Chuck Gowdy, look how slow he is.
Right here at the beginning. Start. We got Cape May, who got a good start. We got Sea Isle. Danny Rogers got a good start. But Vince Granese got a good start. But, you know, Mike looks like he's out on the end there. He's getting hit by a couple waves.
Yeah.
He just got hit by another one.
Vince Granese from Atlantic City looks like he has a great start. Ben Swan, he can surprise people here from Cape May Point. Of course, he's the only entry scooter that they have in the race. But you'd like to see somebody from, you know, another Beach Patrol come in the mix.
Yeah, you wonder why they didn't have at least a swimmer come out and swim for the thing. And like what just happened here. Give him a chance to do it and learn from it.
Well, I'll tell you what. It looks like Danny Rogers from Seattle City really has a nice start going for him. But I'll tell you what, Vince Granese in the blue boat. You can't miss the blue boat from Atlantic City.
And Margate's right there with Atlantic City.
Yeah,
Gowdy's right there.
We did say, what we said was, Mike Mcgrath has to place higher, but one of them has to score.
Right.
Yeah.
They can't not score. If Mike doesn't score, Margate wins.
All right, you're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships, brought to you by Mcgann Realtors of Seattle City, a family tradition since 1939. 4111 Atlantis Avenue in Seattle City, home sales, summer rentals, 609-263-7422. And by Blitz's Market in Ocean City, order online at blitzesmarket.com, located at 21st and 34th Street in Asbury Avenue in Ocean City, 609-399-9983. Blitz's home of the Dill Pickle Hoagie. It's really a big dill. Famous Dino's Subs and Pizza of Margate, 8016 Ventnor Avenue in Margate. Dine in or take out, 609-822-6602. Let's go Margate. And by 7th and 11th Street Bike and Surrey Rentals, located at the Boardwalk in Ocean City, open 7 days a week, 7:30 to 12 noon, in business for 30 years. Enjoy riding the Ocean City Boardwalk on great bikes with friendly service, 609-425-5169. And by Leeds Builders, 30 years of building beautiful custom homes. Are you ready for your beautiful house by the sea? Call Leeds Builders, 609-822-4506. When we return, we'll have the finish of the singles. You're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. Saturday morning in the locker room with Billy Schweim, the Phillies and the Reds hook up for a three-game set. Can they hold on to the lead in the NL East? We will recap Game 1. Former Phillies manager of the 2008 World Series championship team, Charlie Manuel, joins us to talk about the Phillies retiring Roy Halladay's number 34. The Eagles played the Steelers Thursday night in South Philly, and we will review the first preseason action. It's the locker room with Billy Schweim, Saturday morning from 10 a.m. to noon on 97.3 ESPN.
New Jersey car owners, stop what you're doing and come see AJ, the trade-in man, at Matt Black Nissan.
Oh yeah, it's on at Matt Black Nissan.
Cancel that service appointment. Let your tires go bald. Don't put another penny in that old car. The value of your current vehicle has skyrocketed, so cash in your vehicle now. Used car values are at an all-time high. Your car may be worth more than you think. New 2021 Nissan Frontier 4x4 truck. Zero due at signing. Lease $349 per month. Stuck in a loan or lease? We can get you released. We'll buy your car for cash, even if you don't buy a car from us. Worried about your credit? Don't sweat it. Get $3,000 back on every 2021 Nissan Murano and pay zero interest for 60 months in Egg Harbor Township, next to Home Depot, or online at mattblattnissan.com. Negative equity will be refinanced into new vehicle. Great qualifications exist. Not all will qualify. 0% APR based on 1667 per thousand borrowed. Offers can't be combined. 36-month, 10,000 miles per year lease. Call 877-289-6670 or go to mattblattnissan.com for complete details. Offer ends 9-6-21. It's on at Matt Blatt Nissan on the Black Horse Pike, Egg Harbor Township.
I'm New Jersey Secretary of Agriculture Doug Fisher. Whether you like them sweet or spicy, Jersey Fresh bell and hot peppers liven up any dish, and they are in season now at your favorite farm market, farm stand, or supermarket. Stay loyal to local Jersey Fresh peppers.
Welcome back to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. We're here in Longport, New Jersey, as the single racers come in. Dan Adams, you got an update?
We did. We had Sea Isles leading it right now, wow, followed by Longport, followed by Margate, followed by Atlantic City, and you can't count Avalon out there in the hunt there as well. So
look,
and
Sea Isle looks
like Sea Isle. Danny Rogers, look at Margate. I'm surprised.
Mike McGrath just got on
Mike
a swell.
Graf, yep. But I'll tell you what, these guys coming right in.
It's a
Danny
tough
Rogers,
angle,
man.
It's a tough angle for us. We see the boats right in front of us. They look
so
closer.
So what are the if Sea Isle wins this, what did you just tell me?
If Sea Isle wins and Margate and Longport don't place, Sea Isle could be the South Jersey champion.
Wow.
But if Margate or Longport places, that's going to wipe
it
out.
I'll tell you what,
it
looks like Chuck Alley's pushing, making a push right now. I'll tell you that.
But
there's
McGrath,
no
Sea Isle right here.
Wow.
And who else we got?
Wow, this is a close race.
That's Ventnor right there.
Ventnor, David Funk, looks like they're crossing boats.
Nah, Ventnor just collided, but who do you got right here to your right?
Looks like Sea Isle, Danny Rogers is going to win this.
Rodney Felice just got away.
Rodney Felice with a big wave, but he broaches.
Yeah.
He broaches.
Mike McGrath on a swell, but it looks like it's going to be Sea Isle.
Danny Rogers, Sea Isle City, with a big win.
Followed by... Looks like it's
Brigantine got turned around in the surf.
It looks like it's going to be
Longport or Ventnor.
Mike McGrath.
Mike McGrath, second place.
Wow,
I'm not going to say it, but I think Longport might have just capped another South Jersey championship with that second
Ocean
place.
Ocean City, Avalon, they're all in at the same time. Ventnor, David Funk. But how about Danny Rogers from Sea Isle City with a huge win?
Hey, this was a lot different than any other weeks. I mean, we had a lot of changes here in the overall.
Wow, they're finishes. Picking the boat up. Yeah. This is cool.
Hey, you know what?
What did I say, Dan? Did I?
You did call
I
him.
I called Danny Rodgers. He's been placing it. Look at this.
And
listen.
And you know what?
Oh, and, they're going nuts.
And you know what? Let's give John Malar a little credit. He said the younger rowers, he wants to see them
did
do it.
Did he say that?
Yeah. And Dan Rodgers, here he is, one of the younger rowers out here tonight, winning a South Jersey championship. He will never forget this night.
Look at him.
And he will live, and he will be on the program for
forever.
Eternity.
Yeah.
Well, he's going to be in the program for the rest of his life.
Yeah, we haven't won the Margate singles rower from Seattle City since Bob Clifford.
Wow. So unofficial, we had, well, officially we got Seattle winning. Unofficial, Mike Mcgrath second. It was tough to see who was third, whether it was Vetner or it was Margate on the end. But let's see if we can get Seattle up here.
Let's see Seattle up here.
Benny.
What a great race. Everybody's hugging him.
Yeah. Longport.
Everybody's hugging him. Guys, David Funk came up and congratulated
him.
You
got him now.
David Funk congratulated him. He's getting hugs by everybody. What a great race. What a great race. Oh, what? I called it, man. I said Danny Rodgers is going to be winning this race. I called it.
Billy, you did call it.
I called it. I said this young kid's been showing me a lot of moxie, and he wins a great race, and we're going to get him up here.
And how about that, Bill? We talked about that. If
what a great race.
We talked about that. If Margate and Longport didn't place in that event,
nice job,
Seattle is the South Jersey champion. But
nice Tom, give him your headset.
There you go.
Here we are once again, unofficially, I believe Longport is the 2021 South Jersey champion.
No, man.
Look at this crowd.
What a race. I predicted you were going to win, dude.
Appreciate you.
I predicted it because, you know, we looked at this race, Danny. You're looking at some great veterans that have come in. Vince Granese, Erich Wolf, Mike McGriff, Chuck Gowdy. You are an up-and-coming guy who's been in every single race this year. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, Danny, how's it feel to be a South Jersey champion? Your name's
feels
gonna,
great.
Your name's going to live on this for eternity.
Your name's going to be in this
program
for the rest of your life.
It's not too bad.
And this crowd that's here for you. How about Seattle and their crowd and their dedication for you here?
We've always got the loudest crowd in Seattle. Always.
Dan, how do you feel right now, man? You just won the singles in the South Jersey championship.
I feel great.
Oh, did you get a good start?
I was up on the start. Crest had a great start, great race the whole time. I was next to him. And then I couldn't really see what was going on the north end. But, yeah, Kubrowski was doing awesome. And he was just my pace boat. Well, I aced him out at the end.
He's still pumped up. You're still fired up.
Dan,
and we got you right on the broadcast here.
Dan, where did you think you turned in the turn? Where were you in the turn?
I think I was second. Crest was definitely got to the flag before I did. Like I said, I couldn't really see the northern lanes. I wasn't looking that far. But I think it was second or third to the turn. And then,
well, what a great race! You rode your heart out. You rode the doubles to start off the night. How does it feel? How does it feel to have to row both events? How does it feel?
It's not as bad as you'd think. It's doubles is like a nice warm up for singles. But
is that right?
I'm going to be sore tomorrow.
Yeah, right.
Hey, we got Danny Rodgers up here. He just won the singles, the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. And Dan, when you get into the shore, you win the race. The whole crew picks you up in the boat.
Oh, yeah.
That was so
awesome.
Cool.
Awesome.
And we noticed that David Funk came up and was the first one to congratulate.
Yes, he was. I haven't seen him all season, I guess, until Margate's. He's awesome. He blew our doors off at Margate's.
he's one of the greatest rowers of the history of South Jersey racing. But, you know, we were talking up here before the start of the race and then when the single started that if Mcgrath and Gowdy did not place in the singles event and you won, which Billy did call, we'll give it to him, Seattle is a South Jersey champion.
But Mcgrath place.
Mcgrath got second place.
Yeah.
So it looks like
we're in it,
back.
Though. But we're in it.
You're in it.
And it looks like we're coming back here to Longport for 2022.
Dan can't be more excited about that.
I am a little biased, but that's okay. But, Danny, you know what? I can't say enough. Your performance tonight was exceptional. You did an outstanding job to represent your Beach Patrol, and not only your Beach Patrol, but your community. And let me tell you, you're going to get shout-outs from everybody down there in that community. You're going to be the superstar. And hats off to you. Great race tonight.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
What I love about it.
Champion.
As former captain of the Beach Patrol at Seattle, this hasn't happened in a rowing race since 1960.
Wow.
Dale Bonzel.
Well,
first place in Atlantic City in the singles.
And this is the second time.
Well, I'll tell you what, Dan. It's just good for me. It's broadcasting these games, these events, and interviewing the winners. to have new blood coming in and represent Seattle City, you know, your first win, to beat some of these experienced guys. I mean, it's a feather in your cap, and I'm really impressed with your effort tonight.
Thank you. I got a couple people I want to shout out. Yep. My doubles partner, Pascal Pico, is awesome. He took me in when I was 16 years old, a 16-year-old rookie. It's been a great 4 years running with him. Great time. My parents, my family, my brothers and my sister, so much fun. And everybody down there yelling their heads off.
All right, Danny, go enjoy yourself. Go celebrate, man. Congratulations, buddy.
Thank you.
Scooter, you can really hear it, man. Look at the support with these guys. It's unbelievable. And the fact is, he's in the record books now for forever.
Yeah, you know, he just set the tone for a lot of these younger rowers, you know. And we were talking about it earlier, how a lot of these guys are older and veterans of this. But you got a young guy who just came in here and beat two big veterans, if not more, you know. So he's going to enjoy himself tonight. I don't think that was Pedialyte or Gatorade in that jug.
Hey, let me tell you something.
It wasn't a fluke, Dan, because I told you,
he's been
right in the mix the whole season.
He has. Yeah. He has, and they've done well in the doubles. But you know what? He's. We're going to hear his name again.
Yeah, I think
we're going to hear him again in South Jersey racing.
Tommy,
we're
how old
hear
is
him
he?
Again in racing.
I don't know.
I don't know how old you think he is, because
early mid-20s.
Yeah, he's a young kid, and like you just said, Dan, he's going to be around for a long time, man.
He is. That's for sure. Definitely going to be around, and you know what? It puts Seattle back on the map. It puts Seattle back in contention to show that they have the ability to be here and be part of this winning tradition. And you know what? What great racing tonight. The swim, we pretty much called what the finish was going to be.
Right.
There was a little flip-flop on 4 and 5 in the swim. The doubles was kind of caught us a little on the blind side, you know, as far as the finish. But it was similar people who we expected. But Gowdy and Graves.
All right, Dan, give us a recap of the first, second in each race. Just first
you
and
want
second.
First,
second, third.
Okay, so we got in the doubles, we got Chuck Gowdy, Chris Graves in first place. We got Danny Rodgers.
So he gets a second in the doubles. Danny Rodgers and Pat Scott.
Yes. It's kind of
pizza.
So he gets a first and a second.
So that's 9 points.
Wow.
Then we got in third place Mike Mcgrath and Sean Duffy. In the swim, we got Joey Tepper in first place. We got Dolan Grisbaum in second place. And we got Zach Vassar in third place. And unofficially, I only have the top two for sure. The third place is unofficial. We're not sure. But we got Danny Rodgers in first, Mike Mcgrath in second, and it was either Chuck Gowdy or Dave Funk in third.
Well, I'll tell you what a great race. The culmination and the finish of the 81st annual South Jersey Lifeguard Championships was pretty exciting stuff.
Really good.
Tom,
really great. It was great stuff, and it was great to see Seattle do that, because I'm from Seattle City, and the last time that happened is eons ago. We were wondering if it was ever going to happen. We've had a couple. Riley and Corcoran did a third place in the doubles. We had Bob Clifford win to Margate's one time, twice back-to-back, but never won the South Jersey title. So this is a great thing for Seattle City Beach Patrol, and I'm super proud of them.
How about that? Tommy Mcgann.
Unofficial, we got Longport winning overall. We got Margate in second by like 1 point
even though Seattle got one.
It all depends on where Chuck Gowdy finished. If he finished third, it's 11 points. If he finished fourth, it's 10 points for Margate. And that's unofficial. That might not be. Yeah. But Seattle's either second or third, but I think pretty sure it's going to be Margate in second overall and Seattle in third.
So we're going to do some business and then ride the truck up to
we're going to get this started here.
You think we're going to hop up to the headquarters?
97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships is brought to you by Mcgann Realtors of Seattle City, a family tradition since 1939, 4111 Landis Avenue in Seattle City. Home sale, summer rental, 609-263-7422. And by Blitz's Market in Ocean City, order online. Joan and Dave Newman do a great job at blitzesmarket.com, located at 21st and 34th Street on Asbury Avenue in Ocean City, 609-399-9983. Blitz's, home of the Dill Pickle Hoagie. It's really a big deal. And by famous Dino's Subs and Pizza of Margate, 8016 Ventnor Avenue in Margate. Dine in or take out, 609-822-6602. Let's go, Margate. 7th and 11th Street Bike and Surrey Rentals, located at the Boardwalk in Ocean City. Open 7 days a week, 7:30 to 12 noon. In business for 30 years. Enjoy riding the Ocean City Boardwalk on great bikes with friendly service. 609-425-5169. And by Leeds Builders, 30 years of building beautiful custom homes. Are you ready for your beautiful house by the sea? Call Leeds Builders, 609-822-4506. All right, when we return, we'll wrap up the 81st Annual South Jersey Lifeguard Championships live from the beach in Longport.
Tonight on Compass Media Network's coverage of the NFL. The 2021 season gets underway as the Cowboys and Cardinals kick off the preseason from Arizona. Hi, this is Jerry Recco. Join Kevin Ray, Danny White, and myself for all the action as the Cowboys score off with Kyler Murray and the Cardinals. Football is back. It's the Dallas Cowboys and the Arizona Cardinals. If it's the NFL, it's right here.
Coverage begins at 9:30 on 97.3 ESPN.
On some models, excludes Corvette with GM financing, excludes price. See dealer for details.
Have you seen what some dealers are now charging for new cars and used vehicles? It's outrageous. But at Bennett Chevrolet, you still pay what GM supplier employees pay for brand new Chevys. Plus, Bennett gives you all the rebates. That's not either or. You get both. And that can save you up to 25% off MSRP. And Bennett has 0% financing available to save you even more. Got a trade? Bennett's paying top dollar. And we mean top dollar. A minimum $7,000 towards any pre-owned in stock. That's a minimum $7,000 for any old clunker you can tow to our lot. And if it's in good shape, we'll pay more. And we'll buy your vehicle even if you don't buy one of ours. And Bennett makes it so easy. No sales pressure, no negotiating, just pure joy. Because our non-commissioned sales staff is paid on your satisfaction, not how much you spend. So you can see why nobody beats Bennett Chevrolet. Nobody. Find new roads at Bennett Chevy, Egg Harbor Township, and BennettChevy.com.
Are you looking for a rewarding new career? Join the United States Postal Service and apply for roles nationwide. Serve your community with pride and receive benefits including competitive pay and opportunities for advancement. Whether you're looking for full-time, part-time, or seasonal positions, we have options that may be perfect for you. The United States Postal Service is an equal opportunity employer. Apply now at usps.com/careers.
Paid for by Bank on Yourself.
Would you get on an airplane if you knew it had a 50% chance of crashing? You may be riding that plane right now. If you have your money in a 401k or IRA and you plan to take out the recommended percentage each year when you retire, your chance of running out of money is 50%. 50%. But there's a better and safer way to secure your income in retirement. Discover how in a free book called Rescue Your Retirement. This wealth building strategy has never had a losing year in more than a century. In fact, even the man who invented the 401k now prefers this method instead. Get Rescue Your Retirement free for just a small shipping charge and enjoy a safe landing and a comfortable retirement. Get this free book and make sure you don't run out of money. Hurry, this offer is extremely limited. To get your free copy, just go to growwealthsafely.com. That's growwealthsafely.com to discover how to rescue your retirement. growwealthsafely.com.
For eligible individuals 18 or older only, not available in Oregon or West Virginia, results vary. See website for details and important safety information.
If your hearing aids are 2 years old or older, you may be missing out on the huge advancement in hearing aid technology now available with Lively Hearing Aids. Switching to Lively Hearing Aids is like going from this to this. You'll be amazed at the difference. Our rechargeable hearing aids last up to 30 hours without a charge. Bluetooth enabled, they can stream music and calls directly through your hearing aids. And adjustable settings in the Lively app put you in control of your hearing. If you've been waiting to replace your current hearing aids because of the cost, the price of Lively hearing aids will be music to your ears. Lively hearing aids cost half the price of most hearing aids, and they're backed by a 100-day money-back guarantee. Try Lively today risk-free for 100 days and save $100 at listenlively.com/radio. That's listenlively.com/radio. listenlively.com/radio.
Why would someone looking for a mortgage at the Jersey Shore take a loan from a company in Detroit or North Carolina or some other far-off place? Online mortgages promise a lot, but don't always deliver. First Bank of Sea Isle City knows the Jersey Shore. We are local lenders. We use local appraisers and provide in-house processing. We understand the unique obstacles of financing in Cape May County. Don't take a chance. Local banking is better. Let us guide you. First Bank of Sea Isle City.
Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Hey, it's Mike Gill from the Sports Patch. If you're an advertising salesperson, how would you like to sell my show, The Sports Patch, here at 97.3 ESPN and Town Square Media? We're hiring new advertising salespeople to sell The Sports Patch, the number one sports talk show in all of South Jersey at the number one media company in South Jersey. Selling the Sports Pass is the job that will take you as far as you want to go. An excellent compensation package awaits you, as does a creative and fun working environment. So join the team on the Sports Bash and Town Square Media. It's truly the most advanced media company in all of South Jersey. Start or build upon your sales career by becoming a member of our team here at 97.3 ESPN and Town Square Media. If you're interested, apply at townsquaremedia.com. Click on careers. Town Square Media is an equal opportunity employer.
It's back to school, and at Matt Blatt Kia, our math is easy. Put zero down, make zero payments for 90 days, or pay 0% financing for 60 months on every new 2022 Kia Stinger and Sportage in stock. Plus, we need your trade. We'll even buy it for cash, even if you don't buy a Kia from us. Used car values are at an all-time high. Your car may be worth more than you think. Worried about your credit? Forget it. We finance your future, not your past. All new 2021 Kia Niro EXEV with zero due at signing and zero security deposit. Lease just $275. Five per month. It's basic math. Zero down, zero payments, or zero interest for 60 months.
It's gotta be a Matt Black Kia.
Offers with approved Tier 1 or 2 credit through Kia Motors Finance. Not all will qualify. 0% based on 1667 per 1,000 borrowed. Negative equity financed into new loan. Nero 36 month lease, 10,000 miles per year. Excludes taxes, title, license, and docking. Offers don't combine. Call 877-289-6670 or go to MattBlackKiaNJ.com for complete details. Expires 9-6-2021.
Matt Black Kia, 6211. Black Horse Pike. Egg Harbor Township.
And now on Route 37 in Tom's River.
New Jersey Secretary of Agriculture Doug Fisher here. Right now, we are in the height of the Jersey Fresh growing season. That means all your favorite ripe and flavorful Jersey Fresh fruits and vegetables are available now at your favorite market. Stay loyal to local, Jersey Fresh.
The Philadelphia Eagles play on 97.3 ESPN-FM. This Eagles season, listen to every game with the voice of the Eagles, Merrill Reese and Mike Quick. Pre-game coverage from the Eagles Radio Network starts 1 hour before kickoff. Your official home for Eagles football in South Jersey is 97.3 ESPN-FM. Brought to you locally by
Boardwalk Honda. From Maine to Miami, nobody beats a Boardwalk deal. Online at BoardwalkHonda.com. Calvi Electric, now offering residential services for your home and business. First Bank of Sea Isle, Cape May County's community bank. GMS Law, make the right call with four convenient locations to serve you. Visit GMSLaw.com. Cape Regional Health System, for a healthier life. Call 609-463-CAPE. And BMW of Atlantic City, closer than you think. Online at BMWAtlanticCity.com.
We're back here for 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. We're in a military truck as we're riding off the beach. It will be a little noisy, but we'll try to do the best we can. Now, unofficially, Dan, what are we looking at for the finals as we approach the headquarters, the Longport Beach Patrol headquarters?
Let's give the finals real quick from the singles real quick. We had Sea Isle Danny Rodgers winning. We had Mike Mcgrath finishing second. We had Dave Funk finishing third. We had Kabarowski finishing fourth.
Wow, Derek Kabarowski from Wildwood Crest.
We had Ryan Dunn from Ocean City finishing fifth.
Wow, Ocean City got a fifth. That's surprising.
So unofficially, we got points here. We're looking at Longport with 12 points in first place. We got Sea Isle City with 9 points in second place. And Margate in third place with 8 points.
As we get a police escort off the beach in this Army truck, that's a 5-ton Army truck that we're broadcasting top of. Dan Adams got this all set up. There's a huge crowd at the headquarters, the Longport Beach Patrol headquarters, and we're going to get to the stage area, Scotty McKay, and we're going to watch the presentation of the trophy, which will be pretty cool. It's the first time that we'll be able to be as close to the action as possible. We're here live on the street at the stage at the Longport Beach Patrol headquarters. It's pretty cool, Scooter.
When did you think the last time Chuck Gowdy didn't place in a race? Top five.
It's been a while.
It's been a long time, man. That's surprising. But he had a bad start.
What's that you
Gowdy
said?
Gowdy had a bad start.
Gowdy did have a
last
start.
Last time he didn't place in the top five, you know?
Yeah, but what a great finish. What a great race. We talked about it. It was going to come down to that race. And it was really coming down to, we thought, Mike Mcgrath and Chuck Gowdy finishing.
Right.
And what did we say? You got to score in all three events.
Yep.
And what did Longport do tonight?
They scored in all three events.
And they're the only beach patrol, I believe, that scored in all three events tonight.
What I liked about, Scooter, what I liked about this race tonight, and I know you don't want to hear it, but Danny Rodgers, young,
hey, up-and-coming. 19 years old.
Up-and-coming kid. But you know what? I mean, to see the fresh blood coming into these races and pushing these older guys, Dan.
They really are, and they really did a good job. And he's going to be around. We jokingly said that we're going to see him around for a while. He's 19. We're going to see him around for a long time.
And he's a big kid.
And
yeah,
he's
a big kid.
I mean, I'm 6'4". He stood up next to me, pretty close next to me.
As one of your interns said, he doesn't look 19, that's for sure.
No, I got to tell you, Scotty McKay, when you win a race like this of this magnitude, we said that earlier, but you know, you could see when he got up on the, when he got out of the boat, when you came in, the whole beach patrol picked his boat up with him in it, and I mean, how excited were these the kids, the people from Sea Isle?
Yeah, they've always been over the years, from back in the 70s when I started. Sea Isle always had that Sea Isle.
Yeah, Sea Isle.
They had that chant for years. I remember hearing it. Even when they didn't win, they were yelling it.
And
sometimes.
How about that chant tonight? Danny Rodgers.
Right, yeah. Right.
It was great.
We hear there's a party for Danny tonight. Is that right?
Well, I jokingly got a text from relatives that I have. You know, shout out to my family down in Sea Isle, the Clearys, the Pedrazas, you know, my man Joe Pa down there. But they're down there. They're listening to the race live because they always listen to me and follow me when I'm on these shows. And they were real happy to see that Danny Rodgers from Sea Isle won. They want to know where he lives because they're going to his house and his street for the party because it's going to be a good one.
Rennie, obviously, the captain down there, I think right now he's out looking for a swimmer.
Yeah, right.
He's got a double screw. He's got a single screw. And just not that their swimmer was bad tonight, but if they can get him to finish in the top three,
that's a good point, Scotty McKay. They finished second in the doubles, first in the singles. All they need is a swim.
Let me tell you, I'm not going to confirm or deny. But this could be Joey Tepper's last season.
Wow.
He's going into University of Tennessee. He was a freshman last year. He's going back as a junior, and he's in engineering.
Yeah.
So he's going to have to get an internship.
Well, didn't John Tepper, didn't he?
Snuck one extra year in and was able to do it. But I can't see that. But you know what? Longport's got Megan Fox. She's a tough competitor. She's swam well.
No, she didn't swim tonight.
No, she goes well because Joey Tepper swam.
Oh, right.
But she swam swam Wednesday night in the women's race.
Okay,
won.
Right.
So, I don't know. You know, what are you feeling? What do you think? Do you want to get any people up here? We can get the ladder down. You could get some people up here.
Yeah,
we'll
see if we can try to get maybe Mike Mcgrath.
All right.
To Mike, we can
Let
talk
see what
to
I can do.
Who else we can talk to? Who else? Even Seattle's double, Dan. Pat Scampico. Yeah, Pat Scampico.
Yeah, and you saw that. You know, his partner in the doubles with Danny
Rodgers.
He first thing he said, you know, I got to give him all the credit.
Yeah.
He's the one that brought me in the boat and did all the stuff and made him the champion that he is today.
Get Dan Scampico up here. We'll see if we can talk to him. Tell you what, the broadcast, the event, great event tonight here on 97.3 ESPN. We're up here at the headquarters awaiting the final results for the race here, the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. Got a few minutes left in the broadcast, and I'll tell you what, man, this is such a fun event. I'm looking down Atlantic Avenue, and the police are out, the cones are out, they're directing traffic. We had a pretty, really good crowd tonight, Scotty McKay.
And now, you know what? It's nice that it got a little cloudy. It cooled it down a little
bit. Yeah.
It was 95 on my thing as I was coming off of the parkway tonight down here, which is crazy. So
I'd like to see if we could get Dan Scampico from Seattle's double because
– We got to move up just a little bit.
Well, watch him at the ladder.
Hold the ladder.
We're on the fly here, as we learn, some things. We're having a great time here. It's a lot of fun. There's a lot of people, a lot of the beach patrols are still here. I see a television camera off in the distance, so it's a pretty great night for Longport. Put a pretty good show tonight, Dan.
This was a great night, and you know what? Longport's gone out of their way the last couple years. It looks like they're getting ready to start the awards, but Longport's gone out of their way to have a little concert effect, have a great night, a great event. They have the old 1970 alumni wood boat out there that our prior captain who retired, Pat Armstrong, redid and refinished.
And, that's awesome.
You know, just a great night for racing. And once again, hate to say it, Bill, but I'm going to say it, a great night for Longport.
Well, I'll tell you what.
We're not shocked.
But I'll tell you what, Longport, the great competitors, Mike Mcgrath, Sean Duffy, Joey Tepper, and then, of course, Mike Mcgrath doubling up in the singles. Tough team to beat.
It was. And you know, the only part that, you know, my heart breaks, and, you know, I was hoping to see Sean Duffy win his first South Jersey championship. But, hey, they were gunning for him, and they were gunning for Mike and him. They set the pace all year. So that's just the way it was. And
we got about 10 minutes left in this broadcast, Dan. I don't know if we're going to be able to hang on for the results, but I'll tell you what, they sure look like they're having a lot of fun down there at the outside of the tent. They're on the tennis courts here where the stage is set, the band's playing. They're getting ready to present the trophies and the awards to the competitors that won the races as people file in off the beach into the tennis court. Of course, you can see a TV camera. And Scotty, this is just such a great event.
Yeah, you know, this is kind of like, I hate to say this is, because there's still
a little bittersweet, right?
Well, there's still a couple races left in the season, but this is like kind of trying to tell you, guys are going back to college now. Guys are getting their sports. They're ready to go at the end of this, after this race.
And think about what the race next week, what that brings
us.
The Gowdies. What a true way to end the season on true what the lifeguards show every day.
Yeah.
And you'll see a change. You're going to see a lot of the same competitors, but you're going to see a change because a lot of the guys that row in the Gowdies end up being the guys that actually work the stand every day, and they row together and practice together.
Ex-Gowdy champion right here.
And they do a great
job.
He's got his mug.
I got my mug, my 81, I think it was.
All right, let's welcome in from Longport.
Thanks.
Mike Mcgrath, who's just a stalwart in these races. Mike, congratulations on a great race. Longport wins its fifth South Jersey Lifeguard Championship.
In a row.
I appreciate it. This one was a tough one.
It was a tough one. Mike, you got third in the doubles. Gowdy and Graves. Gowdy and Graves have a good showing?
They had a great showing. We were with them the whole way out. I don't think they got – they might have had a boat on us at one point. And, I think by the flag, they might have had a half a boat. We turned every swell we got on, they got on. So it was kind of just us pushing each other. And then, I don't know, we just couldn't make up any ground on them. And then I think we were just focused on them. We really didn't – we saw Ventnor and CI on the other end of the course. But we thought that little swell at the end was going to carry us in the second. But of course, the
doubles crew of Danny Rogers and Pat Scampico, the young guys pushing you old guys.
Someone's got to.
Hey, we actually found out how old Danny Rogers was. He's 19.
Wonderful.
Yeah, isn't that great?
So he's going to be around for a while. But, Mike, before you came up, we were talking about it. And, you know, this is Longport's fifth South Jersey championship in a row. But, you know, and these guys know because I sit here and I always, you know, pull a little extra Longport in. But we were really pulling for Sean Duffy tonight to get his South Jersey championship. But you know what? You guys will be back again next year. We'll be right there doing the same thing. And hopefully we can, you know, pull off another victory. But you guys had a great season. You guys had an awesome performance. And, you know, it just, you know, everything didn't align tonight for what the finish was going to be. But in the end, you're South Jersey champions as a team once again. And we talked about that too. You have to score in every event to win this race. And this was a rerun of 2016 in Avalon.
Yeah.
It came down to the same factors and where you had to finish in the singles in order for this to happen.
Yeah. I mean,
did you know that going in, Mike?
Yeah.
You knew you had to beat Gowdy, correct?
Basically it, yeah. I mean, which is exactly what was happening in 2016.
And let me tell you something. If you didn't score, but you still beat Gowdy and didn't score,
then
Seattle is just the team champion sitting here tonight.
Mike, let me ask you a question. I know you've won a bunch of races now. That first one in 2016, that was extra special because it was the first one? Or have they all gotten better?
No, I mean, the first one's always gonna like
stick
stay. Yeah, that one, because no one expected us.
Right.
Like we were last place beach patrol for how long? And so that first one down in Avalon, that was our first race victory,
right.
Let alone overall victory. So that one's gonna stick with me forever. But I mean, winning the first one here was also great. I think that was the first time John Tepper won.
Yeah.
I think we got third in that one in doubles, and I think I got second in singles in that one as well. So I think it was the same lineup we had this year.
Same scenario that you had to score to win.
And watching, I still remember that. And when we saw Tepper get up and we saw the Rowan cap, we knew it was him and we knew it was in a good shape.
Yeah, but Scooter McKay, Joey Tepper made a critical mistake coming through the surf.
He did.
I mean, he came up north and he stopped. He got out of the water at the sandbar, stood up,
stopped
swimming.
I watched it.
And then he realized he looked around and saw Dolan Grisbaum on his tail,
right.
Who was coming in ahead of
him.
Came
in right on
a
better path
there. That race was a lot closer in the finish than it really should have been.
Yeah.
If Tepper would have kept going and finished out, he wins that race by 25, 30 yards, and there's no question. It ends up almost being a foot race. In another 5 yards, that's a foot race, and whoever touches the rope first is the winner.
So, I mean, once again, Joey came out on top, though. So,
three times in a row, South Jersey champion.
Yeah, him three, and then the year before was John. So,
we got Teppers for 4 years straight swimming.
And the
South
2 years
Jersey
before
title.
That were McKenzie's from Brigantine.
Yeah. Hey, Mike, how ironic was it that you guys at Margate are 1-2 by a draw? I mean, kind of funny how that ends up happening. That was
one of the things that Sean and I talked about going into drawing lanes and everything. They were like, we just said, as long as we're next to, we wanted to be next to Ventnor as well, but they ended up all the way on the other side of the course.
Right.
But
lane 13 on Friday the 13th.
Yeah. So, we wanted to be next to them. So, when you're rowing next to somebody, you know exactly where you are. You're not looking down the other end of the course and kind of guessing where you're sitting with them. So, They drew, they showed us that they got two, and we showed them we got one.
That's great.
We were both happy.
That's great.
You know, Mike, I'm just going to say it. You know, we talked about it in the weeks coming, where Longport's been finishing as far as the team titles. Every big race that we've been in, with the exception of the Atlantic City Lifeguard Invitational, not classic, but Longport won the team championship this year. To me, we talked about it. It is kind of a little bit of a dynasty of what's going on here and where Longport's going and where they've been. And it's really come a long way. And that's hats off to you, Sean, the Teppers, and the Beach Patrol as a whole, because everybody has to come together and be a group to make this happen. And they all came out and they supported, and everybody's here. So hats off to you. Hats off to Longport. Congratulations on a South Jersey championship.
And I know one guy home is home listening to the broadcast. You can't be more pleased. Is Chief
Matt Kelm.
Yeah, and I mean, when we first started winning this stuff, I mean, it was the atmosphere of the Beach Patrol, and I like that went a long way with you, Dan. Like, just
carried over
the atmosphere that we had back then, and trying to build a winning team, and us all working together. Like, when we started winning, the first year we won South Jerseys was the first year we won the Red Bull race. So them winning that race kind of like pushed Sean and I and John at the time like to get in gear and like actually think that we could do it. So like that team in a way pushed us, and then they did it two more times after that. So
all right, I got to ask you, because I had a conversation with Dan not too long ago about do you really love doing both, or would you hope that somebody would finally come out and say, I'm going to take the singles and give you a break?
I would love for someone to beat me in singles. No, I actually love doubling up. I would prefer doubling up than to just rowing singles. I feel like I don't get warmed up enough in just just rowing singles. So, like, if I just row doubles, that's on someone else to row singles, I guess. But,
right.
But if I'm rowing singles, I would prefer to row doubles before.
All right, well, Mike, congratulations on another great race. Longport wins the 81st annual South Jersey Lifeguard Championships. Dan Adams, Scotty McKay, guys. Dan Adams, thank you so much for all you have done for all three broadcasts, the Dutch Hoffmans, the Margate Memorials. We really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And real quick, just thank you again to Longport Fire Department for helping us get this here today, the 5-ton truck, and for their donation to make all this happen. And Margate FMBA Local 41 help.
Thanks,
we appreciate it. It's been my pleasure to work alongside you guys here tonight. And I've had a great time, a great experience. I love doing this. This is just something I love. So thank you.
Scotty McKay, thank you so much. We'll see you tomorrow. We got Charlie Manuel, Phillies manager of the 2008 World Series Championship, Philadelphia Phillies, tomorrow in the locker room with Billy Schweim. This is Billy Schweim, 97.3, signing off from the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships live from the beach in Longport. See you tomorrow, everybody.